change in Syria as separate things, and have insisted that they could work simultaneously to undermine both Assad and the Islamic State. In reality, the U.S. simply does not have any meaningful allies left in Syria, and they're desperate to the point of trying to create a new rebel faction just so they have someone to back. And despite admitting a huge problem with their current strategy, General Martin Dempsey insisted U.S. policy towards Syria will not change, and they'll remain hostile towards both the Islamic State and Assad at the same time. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first, he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports an off-duty Saudi Arabian Airlines plane was seen receiving routine maintenance at an Israeli airport, causing the airline to cancel its contract with the Portuguese firm. The airline, known as Saudia, said HiFly, a company leasing planes to the airline, landed the plane with prominent Saudia markings at Ben Gurion Airport in Tel Aviv, Israel, a violation of its contract. Saudi Arabia has no official relationship with Israel and has led the Arab boycott against Israel since the 1970s. The plane, an Airbus A330, was serviced at the airport last week by Bedeck, an Israeli company contracted by Israeli Aircraft Industries. A Saudi plane arriving in Israel was a novelty noticed by Israeli media. The Saudi newspaper Arab News, quoting the contract, reported, "Such landing or operation process should take place in a country that shares diplomatic relations with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to enable Saudia staff and civil aviation authorities to conduct inspection and follow up on the maintenance operation at any time." For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a former CIA officer was sentenced on Monday to 42 months in prison for leaking classified information to a New York Times reporter about a failed U.S. effort to undermine Iran's nuclear weapons program, according to the Justice Department. Jeffrey Sterling was convicted of disclosing national defense information and obstructing justice in January in federal court in Virginia. Dana Bonte, U.S. attorney for the Eastern District of Virginia, said, "For his own vindictive purposes, Jeffrey Sterling carelessly disclosed extremely valuable, highly classified information that he had taken an oath to keep secret." The Justice Department said that in 2003, Sterling gave information about the clandestine program to a reporter for the New York Times. The reporter, James Risen, fought for years to avoid testifying in the case, saying he could not discuss his sources. He eventually appeared in court, but answered only basic questions about his 2006 book, State of War, in which he described the operation in Iran. Sterling's conviction was a victory for the Justice Department under the Obama administration, which has come under criticism from journalists for aggressively prosecuting unauthorized leaks by government employees. The Justice Department said that in 2000, Sterling, at the time a CIA employee, tried to take administrative and civil actions against the agency. When those moves were unsuccessful, he leaked information about the weapons program in retaliation. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In a survey, nearly 100% of boys ages 12 to 15 report that they have sex all the time and are definitely not virgins. Teens say they've gone all the way on numerous occasions, including vaginal sex, oral sex, and regular sex orgies.
Previous studies suggested that most boys lose their virginity at 16 or 17. But when we gathered 13-year-olds in a room and asked them if they'd had sex, they not only said yes, but they also were clear that sex was no big deal for them, that they weren't nervous before having it, and that when they do have sex, they do it for hours at a time.
And you discovered that these young teenagers have sex with nearly every attractive woman they know, including their babysitters, teachers, and even Hollywood celebrities.
10% of boys in junior high school say they received a blowjob from Katy Perry while they were on vacation in Los Angeles.
And what about teenage girls? Did your study find out anything new about their sexual habits?
We didn't talk to any teenage girls. The boys we surveyed told us not to because they'd probably just lie and deny it.
This is the Onion News Network.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. We will take your calls about anything you would like to discuss here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Drop on by freetalklive.com and enjoy the features that we share with you there. We're going to talk a little bit about smuggling tonight. Mark, you actually sent me a story about a dark web drug dealer, an alleged dark web drug dealer, somebody who sells, is this a dealer or recipient? I'm not sure about this. It says here dealer. Anyway, somebody who was getting drugs shipped to or from was busted, and they were using the underground dark web to do so. Sites like the Silk Road, which we've talked about so many times. So I want to share that story with you here. But in other smuggling news to start things out, this story coming out of the Daily Mail at dailymail.co.uk, where, according to the story here, more than 24 critically endangered cockatoos were rescued by police after being found stuffed in water bottles for illegal trade.
Cockatoos stuffed in water bottles.
Yes, and there are pictures of cockatoos in water bottles. How you manage to get a cockatoo into a water bottle, I'm not really sure. But nonetheless,
the smugglers are resourceful people.
Yep, the smugglers crammed the yellow-crested cockatoos into empty bottles so they could get through customs at the port of Tanjung Perak in Surabaya, Indonesia. But Indonesia police discovered the birds, which can be sold for as much as £650 each, and cut them free so they could receive medical attention. The yellow-crested cockatoo was listed as a critically endangered species by the International Union for the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources in 2007.
So are there, I mean, I feel like I've seen yellow-crested cockatoos in the past, and where I would have seen them would be people's homes. I can remember mm-hmm. specifically a friend of my mother's when I was younger had a house full of birds. It was insane how many bird cages was in this house. And she was a bit of a breeder, as you might imagine, by having all those cages in the house. So is it hard to breed these birds in captivity? It seems like they've been in captivity a long time. My normal go-to on this would be, see, the yellow-crested cockatoo is endangered by these stupid endangered species laws. But
well, that's true.
It sounds like there might be a problem with the species breeding in captivity or something.
So it appears what they do is they cut the bottoms off of the bottle.
Yeah, that seems obvious. They certainly didn't put it through the tiny little hole people drink out of.
Shove the bird into the bottle. The population of the birds is at a critical low due to deforestation, says the piece here at Daily Mail, and poaching, and recent studies suggest there may be less than 7,000 individual birds remaining. More than 10,000 parrots, including lories and cockatoos, are caught from the wild in North Halmahera, Indonesia, each year to supply the domestic and international illegal wildlife trade. So this is kind of what you're talking about there, Mark. And by the way, Rich Paul joining us in studio tonight as well. Hello, Rich.
Hey, Ian.
So, anyway, what you were saying, Mark, was that, you know, but because these birds are illegal to own and they're illegal to trade, they're illegal to buy, sell, give away, because of that, they fetch a higher price than they otherwise would if there was a legal marketplace, just like drugs, right? So when drugs are made illegal, when alcohol is made illegal, when gambling, when prostitution, whatever it is, when birds, in this case, are made illegal, they go into the underground. They go into the realm of the criminal distribution element, and now you've got criminals who are shoving birds into plastic bottles so they can pack them into whatever they were packed into, a box of some sort of shipping crate or whatever, and fit as many of these birds into a small space as they possibly can to hopefully successfully smuggle them through some border somewhere to take them to their ultimate destination where they'll be distributed to whoever the people are that are looking to buy these birds. And there are people who are looking to buy these birds, obviously.
You better believe it.
They're willing to pay hundreds of pounds for one of these birds, and so they're willing to pay a price – that is motivating to a criminal to go ahead and take the risks that are necessary, possible felony charges or whatever, to smuggle these birds.
If you're poor enough, anything's going to be worth it.
Yeah, for sure. And so, you know, think about how this would be different or could be different if the birds were actually legal to own and sell. Because if they were legal to own and sell, you'd have a situation where, okay, there may be some companies who you didn't agree with how they raise the birds, like, you know, the way they call them, the puppy mill puppies.
Yeah.
I think these are the kind of puppies that are raised in these supposedly unsafe conditions with deleterious effects on the wellness of the dogs.
So well, there are hold on. When it comes to puppy mills, there's everybody has their own opinion as to what a puppy mill is, yeah, too. So
I've never been to a puppy mill, so I have no personal experience.
A lot of people out there, basically, if you breed a dog, you are a puppy mill.
Okay.
Right? Like, so
I don't know that.
My mother bred one dog a year for a few years when I was young, and some people would call her a puppy mill simply because she had purebred dogs, and that's just not acceptable for whatever. Mm. And there are other people out there that, you know, these people often say, you got to rescue a dog for this dog to be sort of legitimate. And a rescue can look like anything, right? Like we rescued them from the puppy mill by buying them from the puppy mill. I mean, like, what is a rescue? Do you have to run in and grab the dog and run out? I mean, is it somebody who didn't want a dog? There's all kinds of things. There's terminology that floats around here. I think that the shaming that goes on around animals can be really detrimental in that way.
Well, I mean, I was using the term puppy mill to describe some sort of large operation where the dogs aren't treated very well and they end up sick at the end of it because of inbreeding or the conditions or whatever. I don't have intimate familiarity with it, but when I think of puppy mill, I don't think of an individual breeder who's taking good care of.
You're supposed to, because it's a loaded term.
You're supposed to think of individual breeders,
too? No, you're supposed to think of, this large thing. That way, somebody who, you know, wants to use a loaded term can refer to anybody as a puppy mill, and you get this idea in your mind that they're somehow kept in, like, some unair-conditioned tobacco barn full of dogs with one eye.
My point in bringing that up was to point out that there are places, right, where, you know, dogs are brought up in undesirable conditions, right?
That, so, I would assume.
Well, just because of the nature of people, some of them are going to be more attentive to certain things than others, right? The same thing with chickens. This is a big deal with chickens, with the free-range chickens.
Yep.
Right? This is important to you, Mark. You're a farmer.
Well, we get free-range eggs.
You had chickens. You don't do them anymore, right?
God, no. I slipped on chicken poop a couple of times going out to get the eggs in the middle of, or going out to take care of the chickens in the middle of winter, because you don't get eggs in the when they're molting and when it's cold. And I'm just, you know, like, no. Ice and chicken poop don't mix. I'm not in. I'm out. Hmm.
So anyway, the point being that in a legal market of exotic birds, I acknowledge there would probably be some people raising birds in a way that maybe others would have an issue with. But on the other hand, there would be people raising cockatoos in a very respectful manner and selling them in a very respectful manner, to where nobody's shoving a cockatoo into a water bottle to try to transport it, right? If you were buying a bird in the legal market, it's going to come to you in a much more safe manner. And it will certainly come to you in a manner that will make it less likely to die in transit. According to the story here at the Daily Mail, around 40% of smuggled birds die during the illegal smuggling process.
They might as well, right? Like, they got to get the birds through in some way or another. If there's going to be an attrition rate, this is basically the same as the slave ships coming from Africa, right? Who cares if some of them die, as long as we get the payout at the end?
So for every 1,000 parrots caught from the wild, 400 birds died in vain during the poaching, transportation, and trade due to poor conditions and cruel handling. According to the story, most parrots are prohibited from international commercial trade unless they are a captive bred or permitted by the exporting country. Yellow-crested cockatoos also breed very slowly and lay eggs only once a year. They can produce only two eggs at a time. Illegal trapping continues in many areas, including Rawa, Alpa, Watsumohai National Park, Bhutan, and Katdua Islands, but it has reportedly been reduced significantly on Sumba. Large-scale logging.
It sounds like the demand, cockatoo breeders just aren't keeping up with the demand for cockatoos, sadly.
Well, if they could operate legally, it might be a lot easier for
the breeders
to do that.
It's illegal generally in a lot of places to sell these things.
To sell them, period, unless they're captive bred, it said.
Oh, there's all kinds of restrictions on these, Mark. So there's more coming up here in moments. And also only if the countries allow the import, which I suspect very few do. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, Mark Edge, at mark@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
Gold. It's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233 for the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
If you're looking for work, or even if you're not, here's an innocent mistake you really want to avoid. Never return calls before listening to your voicemail. Your wireless phone sends calls you didn't answer into voicemail, and it shows you phone numbers for calls you missed. Important, don't call back callers you missed until you have first listened to your messages. Otherwise, you frustrate people who bothered to leave messages by asking them to repeat a message they just left, as your voicemail greeting instructed them to. If you're a job applicant, this alone could be a deal killer. And even if you're not, there are few things you can convey to someone that are as fundamentally maddening as, "I didn't hear you." With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important. For more tips for job seekers and everyone else, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. And if you want to help support Free Talk Live, throw some Bitcoin in the Bitcoin tip jar over at bitcoin.freetalklive.com, or maybe you've got some altcoins that you want to get rid of. You can actually send us your altcoins, But shapeshift.io will translate them into Bitcoins for us. They will transfer them, which is awesome. And you can do all of that from bitcoin.freetalklive.com. But if you want to be able to do that, you have to actually have those coins first. And you can get Bitcoin, Litecoin, and Dogecoin all over at expresscoin.com. Expresscoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrency. It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business. You can get your cryptocurrency with money order or check, and you can get started over at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, you can also do it from your smartphone via their app, which you can grab at expresscoin.com. Use coupon code FTL, and you'll get up to $40 worth of the cryptocurrency of your choice with no fee, no transfer fee at all, when you use coupon code FTL at expresscoin.com. As we go to your calls and thoughts, Jim is in Durham, North Carolina. We've been talking about smuggling birds and legalizing endangered species, legalizing the ownership and the sale of those endangered species. But you can also bring up anything you want. Jim, you're on the air listening to Talk Radio 850 there in Durham.
Well, listen, I just wanted to say that anytime you try to legalize something that's illegal, the government gets their hands in it and they start putting regulations and rules and things in place to the point where it makes it almost physically unable for you to be able to buy something that's regulated by a government office. And it actually strengthens, I think, the underground economy to the point you go to it rather than go to a established place to get that commodity, because it's cheaper.
Well, now let's talk about what's happening out in like Colorado or Washington, for instance, where cannabis has recently been legalized and people are buying it. Sure, some are still buying it from the underground, but there are a lot of people who are buying it legally through the, you know, the various distribution channels that have cropped up there. So I don't know if there's a real argument that the underground is going to get any stronger as a result of legalization. If anything, it's going to get weaker because they're going to be subject to greater competition than ever before, which will cut into their profit margins somewhat.
Well, isn't there a supply problem, though? In Washington?
I don't know. Not that I've heard. Rich, have you heard anything?
A supply problem of laws in Washington, D.C.?
No, of cannabis.
Okay.
Yes. There's a supply problem, and people are having to go to the underground economy because of the supply problem. That's what I've been reading.
Yeah. Well, that will happen in a regulated industry anytime you... when you mess with the market, you will create problems, and this is not a free market out there. It's a little bit freer because marijuana is legal, but
I don't know, Jim.
If there's only licensed producers, that can happen, but there shouldn't be a supply problem if it's not about licensed producers.
I don't know where that information is. Just to clarify, I don't know where that information is coming from. I don't see news about it. I just searched for it, and there's a story from just a few months ago. Washington's pot supply is driving down price. There's a glut of cannabis.
That's exactly the point I'm trying to make.
Well, that's not a supply problem. If there's too much, that's not a problem.
The legal supply is where the problem is.
So what you're saying is there's a supply problem.
The underground economy for marijuana has gone down.
The underground economy marijuana?
The pricing on the underground cannabis has gone down.
That's not a problem.
That's a good thing.
That's a good thing for the buyers.
Low prices mean efficient production.
Yeah. Jim, when you said there was a supply problem, I interpreted that to mean that there was not enough to feed the demand. And if that was what you meant, you're wrong. But what you're saying is, by supply problem, you mean there's too much marijuana. That, by no definition, is a problem except for the producers who might have overproduced, in which case they'll have to lower their prices to sell out whatever remaining stock they have so the customers benefit.
All I'm saying is that's what's going to happen with, say, birds.
Yes, absolutely. You know, the price of birds, if you make it legal for people to breed and sell birds legally, domestic birds, then the wild ones will get, at that point, too difficult to catch for the price, because you'll drive down the price because there'll be more legal birds.
And again, there's no problem with that. Why do you see that as a problem? Lower prices, greater supply.
I think we just got started off on the wrong foot. I think we agree with each other. I was just trying to make the point that it would necessarily drive the prices down.
Yeah, right.
That's
every
a
time.
Good thing. Yeah. And that's what we want to have happen. Not only will it drive prices down, but it'll make it so the birds are treated better by the people who are raising them. When they're shipping these birds, they won't ship them in water bottles, shoved into bottles in, you know, unsafe, dangerous conditions that are resulting in nearly half of the birds perishing in transit. So you'll have...
It'll be in small cages in the bottoms of planes.
Maybe so. It's certainly better than being shoved in a bottle. Anything else you want to share with us tonight, Jim?
I hope you guys have a great evening. I appreciate the show. It's always informative, and it's on so many different levels. I really enjoy the program.
Hey, thanks, Jim. Do me a favor, then, if you really like Free Talk Live, and call WPTK there in your area and tell the program director that you appreciate that they have Free Talk Live on the air. I know they'll appreciate hearing from you. If you take a moment to do that, I appreciate that. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. So let's just make sure we're clear on this. A glut of supply is not a problem.
Well, it is if you're the supplier.
If you're the supplier, it's a problem. But as far as the consumer's perspective, as far as the, you know, the world's perspective, as far as, you know, what is happening out there, it's better to have more of something than less of something.
Yeah, when you have a glut of something, what you're going to see is the inefficient producers shutting down. And that's exactly what they should do, so their capital can be liquidated and used to start some other enterprise where there isn't, and that will resolve the glut.
Right. I don't know why people want these fancy chickens, but you know, there's a certain amount of people in a marketplace that want yellow crested cockatoos, and fine, they should be able to get them if that's what they want to do. If there are 10 people that want them and five birds that are available for sale, you're going to see the price be rather high.
Mm-hmm.
If there are 10 people that want them and 15 birds for sale, then you're going to see people, the price is going to be much more reasonable on them. It's going to, producer's going to look at, well, how much does it cost me to produce this? And is this worth it? I've got to bring my prices down. And at the lower prices, it's still worth it to me. You know, and some people are going to say yes, and some people are going to say no. And that's just how it goes. Some people are going to breed birds and sell birds for the love of birds, and that's even going to throw the market off, drive the price down even further, because those people don't want to make any money.
Yeah.
At that point, you're only going to have birds that are lovingly cared for, and then everybody's happy. The marketplace has the best solution here.
It absolutely
does. For people that want fancy, expensive chickens.
And you have to allow the market to work to come up with the best solutions, because when people look at the idea of getting rid of an endangered species, what I mean by that is getting rid of the list of endangered species, they bristle at that and they say, whoa, we've got to protect these species. But what they don't realize is that the government is putting them in greater danger by setting them in this protected class.
I still say the best thing to do is go to the feed store in the spring and buy a chick for 99 cents and raise it. Produce eggs for you.
855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Here, you can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
The Genesis Communications Network is one of America's premier broadcasters of captivating talk radio. We thank you for listening. Now, just imagine, there are thousands of people who are just as passionate about radio as you are. But what you may not realize is how easy and affordable it is to advertise with us. Radio commercials for your business could be heard on hundreds of radio stations across the U.S. every day. We can help you by creating an effective radio advertising campaign for your company. From script writing to producing your commercial, just like the one you're listening to right now, no other network provides the level of customer service we do. When it comes to radio advertising, we are your one-stop shop. And no matter how big or small your business is, we can help. Email us at advertise@gcnlive.com, and an experienced advertising executive will help you take the first step towards driving more customers to your business or website. advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com now.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live.
You guys live in a dream world.
No, sir, you're the one that lives in a dream world. You're the one that wants to have a police state in America where you get to determine who can come in and who can't. You want to have border patrols. You want to have checkpoints.
You want to let the entire third world into this country?
Sir, I'll answer that question by reading a short excerpt from a poem. Maybe you've heard of it. It happens to appear at the bottom of the Statue of Liberty. It was about...
Give us your poor, your tired, huddled masses.
Great, you are aware of it, yes.
Let them come in legally.
Lou. The legal is such a cop-out. No, hold on a second. Because when your ancestors came across, and I don't know what they are, let's say they're Italian. When your ancestors came across, all they did was take you to Ellis Island, screw up your last name, sit you around for 3 days, and then bam, you're out the door. Now legal is a huge pile of paperwork and tens of thousands of dollars.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm. Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited here to take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online and drop by freetalklive.com. All the features are free, and they're waiting for you there. So go and enjoy at freetalklive.com. Are you using ProXPN yet? Well, if not, you can go and get started right now for free over at proxpn.com/FTL. And you can download their software for Windows, Macintosh, iOS, Android, Linux, whatever system you're using. There's probably a ProXPN waiting for you. And ProXPN will encrypt your internet connection, meaning your internet service provider will no longer know what you're doing online once you start using ProXPN. Also, anybody that might be trying to sniff out your Wi-Fi packets from your smartphone or your laptop, they will also not have any clue what you're up to anymore. So start using ProXPN right now at proxpn.com/FTL. Then, when you're ready to upgrade to their premium account to get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, private torrenting ability, and getting past regionally blocked websites, you can do that by using code FTL50, FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off the price of the annual account, which breaks down to less than $5 per month. ProXPN.com/FTL, promo code FTL50. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee, and ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits at all. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. It's ProXPN.com/FTL, promo code FTL50. As we continue here, we were talking about smuggling, specifically in this case, smuggling birds. And it's actually been a while since we've had this topic on the show. But
it comes up, you know, kind of regularly.
Yeah, I don't know if it's regular, but
regular can mean every 2 years.
Okay, yeah, maybe. I feel like we've only done it 2 or 3 times over a decade.
Yeah.
But there was one years ago that I actually turned into a promo because I think this smuggling of birds is such an interesting example of how prohibition works and the effects that it has, and that, you know, it's not your typical prohibited product. Normally, when you think of prohibition, you think of drugs, you think of guns, you think of prostitution, gambling, all the vices.
Yep.
But you don't think about animals, and it can be, I think, a real shocker to people to realize that, oh, look. Well, the government bans the raising and the selling of these birds. Many governments do, not all of them, but many governments around the world. The government, you know, labels these things as endangered, ostensibly to protect them. And ultimately, what that does is it puts them in greater danger. It puts them in danger because poachers are willing to go out and risk arrest for capturing these animals. Further, the smugglers are willing to risk arrest for smuggling these animals, ultimately to get them to their final destination of likely some wealthy person's home, because they're
probably is mostly ignorant of what they've done.
That's probably true.
The vast majority of people who buy these animals probably were sold, you know, by a pet store or something like that. Somehow they go from the black or gray market into the white market without people necessarily knowing. I have never been confronted by somebody on the street going, "Psst, hey, want to buy a yellow-crested cockatoo?" Like, that doesn't happen. That's not the way the black market works.
You got to seek them out. And how you find those? Well, that really begs an interesting question: is how do you find these underground connections? I mean, are they buying them on the Silk Road? Is there an animals section in there? Where does one go? It's got to be a who you know kind of thing, like in the rich, well, the halls of the rich. There's
probably people who know. Yellow-crested cockatoos isn't about rich people.
No?
No.
650 pounds? How many dollars is that?
$750. You can pay that for an animal real easily. A show dog will cost you $1,000.
I don't think the average person can pay $700 easily for an animal.
Okay.
There's a lot of relatively poor people who pay hundreds of dollars for pets.
Animals?
This bird's going to live longer than you.
I used to sell weed to some of them, and it would astound me that... You know, this person would say, you know, they'd come through, like, "Oh, yeah, I bought this dog for $600 because it was really cute." And I'm thinking, are you serious?
But they're barely paying their own bills.
Were you trying to trade me food stamps for weed yesterday, you know? And it's weird.
So they're taking care of an animal better than they're taking care of themselves, kind of thing?
Yeah, basically.
Yeah. A show dog will get... between $1,000 to $1,200, depending on the breed and all that stuff. Some even more than that. And a dog lives 10 years. Some cases as low as 6. When you're talking about Great Danes, this bird is going to live as long as you, Ian, if not longer. And so this is not. If you're talking about $1,000 bird, you're not talking about a very expensive thing. I was just looking into heritage breed pigs. Consider, a pig is good for only one thing, people. It produces pork. I was looking at, just regular, what we call white pigs, mixed bred pigs, and blister old spots and mule foots. And the price difference is essentially for a piglet, you're talking 100, maybe 125 for a regular pig. And this year, there's a dearth of piglets, so the prices have been driven up. And versus $350 per pig for a breeding pair. So $700 for a breeding pair of blister old spots. Hmm. And probably similar for the mule foots from what I could tell. But they don't grow quite as big, and I wasn't as interested.
So I guess my question still stands, though, is how do you find these connections? I mean, when you're dealing with drugs, they're fairly popular, right? So you can usually ask somebody, hey, you know, can you hook me up with whoever sold you that bag of marijuana? And you know, if you're friends with that person and that person trusts you, they're likely to go ahead and introduce you to their dealer or whatever. So, you know, there's a word of mouth thing that goes on there. But there are probably not that many people that are interested in yellow-crested cockatoos, you know, on average, that you might know in your general life. So I'm just wondering, you know, how this goes. Is somebody going into the pet store and just wondering aloud, do you have any yellow-crested cockatoos? And then the guy behind the desk is like, well, that's illegal, but I know somebody who knows somebody. I mean, how does the connection get made here?
I've got a guess. I would imagine, this is a guess, that the pet stores are probably dealing with normal bred, domestic animals. these cockatoos, mm-hmm. right? So they're probably coming from sort of legit channels and they check it out a little more. But if you're going to find something like this, you're probably going on the internet to some extent to find things. So oftentimes, if you're buying an animal, you're going to buy it from an individual. We got our retriever from some people that breed golden retrievers, and you can call it a rescue if you want. We got, she has a better life at my house than she did over that house, whatever. And, that's kind of how these things go. If that dog, I wouldn't necessarily know if that dog was smuggled in from Bangladesh. Do you see what I'm saying? So essentially they end up being a front organization. What happens is you basically have to, figure out some way to get it into the country. Once you get it into the country, you find the people who would, hey, I've got some yellow-crested cockatoos. Well, I love those. I'd love to help you sell those. I know lots of people. And then you essentially get that person to... I've got a source for yellow-breasted cockatoos. We have a very prolific breeder, and I'd like to help you with them. And so that's how you get these birds, disseminated, is you've got to find somebody who's going to fit into the culture.
I'm trying to think what I would do if I had a shipment of yellow cockatiels to get rid of, and if possession of them isn't illegal, and it sounds like captive born ones are legal?
I'm not sure. The article here is from the UK. It doesn't go into US law. It is illegal to possess. Probably in some places it's illegal to possess. In others it's illegal to sell or import. So I can't tell you what the legality is in New Hampshire or in the United States.
The other thing you can do is tack up a sign at your grocery store and say bird for sale.
Yeah, we could do that.
Craigslist. Just like you'd get rid of an ordinary pet that was maybe a purebred and you wanted to sell it instead of just finding a good home.
But don't mention the kind of bird publicly.
Maybe
that
don't
could get you targeted,
do.
Right?
I mean, there aren't, as far as I know, federal agents, combing the supermarkets looking for.
I see. So post birds. It on a poster board in real life, but not necessarily on Craigslist.
Or you might put it on Craigslist.
Because that's going to get you attention. I mean, if there is an agent who's investigating illegal bird trade, then posting to Craigslist could very well result in an investigation.
Yeah, right? And the other thing is, I would imagine that people who like birds flock together. And so it might well be
the word just gets
that
around.
There's a lot of word of mouth, but... there are ways you could get rid of it. You can get rid of anything without people.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Coming up, we'll talk about a different kind of smuggling. This, through the mail and drugs. 855-450-FREE. Share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
Warning. If you've recently declared bankruptcy, you're going to want to change the station. Because there's an alternative to bankruptcy, and it's faster than you'd ever think possible. But if you've already declared bankruptcy and have missed this opportunity, you'll want to change the station now. Here it is. Right now, the company that has resolved more credit card debt than anyone in the U.S. is available to settle your debt, too. You may reduce your debt with one low monthly program payment. If you call right now, Freedom Debt Relief will show you how low your monthly program payment could be for free. Call now. 1-800-399-1993. That's 1-800-399-1993. If you're struggling with debt, this could be your answer. And the bigger your debt, the more money you could save. To find out for free how much of your hard-earned money Freedom Debt Relief could help you save, call now. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993. 1-800-399-1993.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to dial in toll-free and share your thoughts with us about whatever you'd like to discuss with us. We're talking about smuggling birds and the sort of the animal underground. It's seems like a really dark area that doesn't get a lot of press coverage, with birds, in this case, cockatoos, being shoved into water bottles, like plastic water bottles, for transport to whichever destination, where they would fetch over 650 pounds in value for each bird. 40% of the birds dying in transit during this whole smuggling process, and basically just taking the position. And Dr. Mary Ruart, I think, deserves a lot of credit for putting this position out there. It's where I learned about it in her book, Healing Our World, taking the position that it's the prohibition of these animals that contributes to their decline, that contributes to their elimination from the world. And that's what they're seeing here with this cockatoo, is that the numbers are going down because no one can own these things in most places. They're considered endangered. You can't own, you can't trade in this bird. So therefore, the only people who are owning and trading the birds are those who are willing to break the law. And that sends those birds underground, and it restricts the supply of what could be available in the world. If you look at legal animals, animals you can legally own, you can legally buy, sell, trade, whether we're talking about dogs, cows, chickens, there's no shortage of chickens and cows, right? All of these things that are so useful in our lives because we've figured out ways to make neat things from them, useful tools or luxury items. And
a lot of this has to do with people's attachment to the animals in an emotional way, right? Like, they're, you know, people think dogs are a wonderful thing until you start saying you want to eat one. Mm-hmm. However, it's, you know, eating, say, raising a pig or a cow or a chicken for food, nobody seems to really have a problem with that. What they say
not
to
as
themselves,
many people.
Yeah, not nearly as many people.
Right.
So it sort of comes down to how we were socialized as individuals to think about individual types of animals. Well, I'm here to tell you there's not much difference between keeping a cockatoo, a yellow-crested cockatoo for a pet, and keeping a cat for a pet, except the cat will eat the cockatoo. There's just not that much of a difference out there. I can see why you might want to prohibit the possession of predators or very strong animals. I get why...
Cats and dogs are predators.
I'm talking about Bengal tigers, my friend. Like, there's a difference between...
Not domesticated predators.
Right. Then. There's a difference between Edith having a little kitty who sits on her lip during the day and having a Bengal tiger, right, that she can't control. And, you know, she lets out to go to the bathroom in the yard. And, you know, it devours people's animals and children and people themselves.
So what were you suggesting about the tiger? I missed that.
I can see why the government might be more interested in prohibiting, predators or something like that, big predators, charismatic megafauna, as it were. But when you're talking about a bird, it's just, I mean, I understand you don't want them taken from the wild. I don't want them taken from the wild either. The problem is prohibiting the trade of domestic birds.
I guess the question for the kind of person who might be listening to this discussion saying to themselves, these animals have rights and they should not be owned and they deserve to be in, you know, not in captivity and not be traded. I think that those people have to choose from two possible worlds. One is the world where you prohibit the animal from being owned, where we see what happens. The animals end up in the hands of smugglers and being severely mistreated. Or the other world where you allow people to own, to possess, to trade, buy and sell in these animals, which will result in more of the animals existing. Now, maybe they won't all exist in circumstances that you find ideal, but more of them will exist, and there's almost zero chance they'll ever go extinct. So I guess the question is, what's more important to you? Is having more of the animals in the world in various different types of captivity and non-captivity worth is that better to you than having them dying off slowly as the smuggling market suffocates these animals to death?
This happened. And what we're talking about here is property rights. And the thing is, there is one counterexample, which is there are places in Africa that I've read about where the native tribes have basically been given property rights in the big game animals. And
right,
so
like
what
elephants.
They do is they take care of them and they make sure that they're okay and they get paid by the small number of hunters that are willing to go in and pay the fee to hunt one of these things. And that's where the money comes from that takes care of the animals. And in those areas, some of those endangered species are
actually
rebounding.
Yep.
Right. This is what happened to the Western black rhino. It was prohibited for it to be hunted. It was prohibited to be sold, traded in, any parts of it and all this stuff. And it has, you know, this subspecies is extinct. It's gone because somebody made a rule so that you can't trade in them. And I mean, I get where, you know, the simpleton would say, well, it seems very simple. We'll just pass a law that says you can't do it. Well, I got news for you. It doesn't work. And it hasn't worked. Please stop doing this.
And it doesn't work in anything. I hear simpletons saying we should. I like that word, simpleton. I'm going to use that. But I think it comes down to this idea that money is somehow bad and dirty. So if something is very important, then we must prohibit the mixture of money with it. But what that means in the real world is we starve it of resources. You know, money is resources. So if you say, well, medicine is too important and therefore it must be free, then you starve it of the money that pays for it. If you say water is too important to be sold and everybody has a right to water, so we're going to prohibit the sale of it, then there's nobody out there purifying water.
Because, indeed.
You know, you can't do things unless you get paid for them.
Yeah, and the belief that money is the root of all evil is a fairly common belief. This is sort of a cliche almost. It's so typical out there that people have that belief. And really, it's not true at all. Money's just a tool. Evil people can use money and good people can use money. So it really just, you know, depends on the intentions of the person who has the money, right?
I remember seeing an article one time that said if they'd taken like the same amount of money that they put into lobbying to save the rainforest and just
saved it.
Bought the rainforest, they could have bought like 75% of it and owned it and protected it.
That is a really great point, because we forgot to point it out, is when you look at things like this, I mean, let's take a look at who's been successful. Just this week, Obama apparently signed something that's going to allow Arctic drilling. And again, the activists are upset. No Arctic drilling! But these are the same activists, likely, that wanted the government to have the you know, wanted some government agency to have control over it so that no one could Arctic drill. Well, this is what happened under a Democratic president. Under George Bush, ANWR was opened up for pipeline or drilling or something like that. This is the Alaskan National Wildlife Refuge. And it just keeps happening. Stop! I mean, because you're falling into the whole watermelon thing, right? You're green on the outside, but you're really red on the inside. Like, you're not an eco activist. You're a socialist because you want to turn everything over to the government, and the government keeps screwing you. Stop it. Stop getting screwed.
A real eco activist would go out and buy the property and put
Like the Audubon Society and Ducks Unlimited and all these organizations that are actually saving land.
And don't forget U.S. paper.
I'm not familiar with that.
I think it's U.S. paper. There are paper companies that own huge tracts of forest.
They do here.
Go out and camp in and do whatever. But then every once in a while they come along and they cut down the trees and they plant some more.
Yep.
You know. And if you're concerned about global warming, that's a great thing to do, because those trees that are cut, some of them are going to become lumber and get built into houses, and that's a great way to sequester carbon.
So you can share your thoughts here. Maybe you disagree and you think prohibiting ownership of birds and other animals is the right way to protect them, even though it seems to me...
I've never heard an argument that makes any sense on this.
Right.
It's all emotional.
Right. All of the evidence is against you if that's what you believe. But if you do believe that, I'd love to hear from you toll free at 855-450-FREE.
It's emotional and it's based on intentional misteaching of the principles of economics also.
And speaking of teaching, this just goes all the way to the heart of the school kids. I recently saw some campaign where the teachers have the kids, you know, to figuring out ways that we can get around without using cars. And now this doesn't have anything to do with alternative resources. This has to do with not using cars. And that's a different thing than, hey, let's figure out other things to oil and stuff like that. And also, I still don't feel like this whole global warming carbon thing has been entirely settled. There's always some news story coming out and saying, oh, that's not true, or whoop, this is true. And it's confusing to just the average person like me.
Well, speaking of traveling.
I'll be more convinced that they're right about what's going to happen in 100 years when they can predict the weather next Tuesday.
We'll be back with more. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
New Hampshire is under quarantine as walking corpses devour the flesh of the living. Max is 11 years old and surviving alone. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the dead swarm his home. Now he must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to improvise his escape. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook, read reviews on Amazon, or read Chapter 1 at SurvivorMax.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.43 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,194 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $243. Antiwar.com reports U.S. officials are expressing sentiments similar to other analysts that in the recent weeks, the Syrian government's momentum has waned and that President Assad faces even more risk from the assorted rebels. The big surprise, however, is the admission from the officials that Assad's loss means gains for the Islamic State and Al-Qaeda's Nusra Front, the two largest rebel factions, and that will be the primary beneficiaries of a fading Assad. U.S. officials have often tried to present the war on the Islamic State and the war for regime change in Syria as separate things and have insisted that they could work simultaneously to undermine both Assad and the Islamic State. In reality, the U.S. simply does not have any meaningful allies left in Syria, and they're desperate to the point of trying to create a new rebel faction just so they have someone to back. And despite admitting a huge problem with their current strategy, General Martin Dempsey insisted U.S. policy towards Syria will not change and they'll remain hostile towards both the Islamic State and Assad at the same time. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his Porcupine Freedom Scouts training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports an off-duty Saudi Arabian Airlines plane was seen receiving routine maintenance at an Israeli airport, causing the airline to cancel its contract with the Portuguese firm. The airline, known as Saldia, said HiFly, a company leasing planes to the airline, landed the plane with prominent Saldia markings at Ben Gurion Airport in Tel Aviv, Israel, a violation of its contract. Saudi Arabia has no official relationship with Israel and has led the Arab boycott against Israel since the 1970s. The plane, an Airbus A330, was serviced at the airport last week by Bedeck, an Israeli company contracted by Israeli Aircraft Industries. A Saudi plane arriving in Israel was a novelty noticed by Israeli media. The Saudi newspaper Arab News, quoting the contract, reported, "Such landing or operation process should take place in a country that shares diplomatic relations with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to enable Saldia staff and civil aviation authorities to conduct inspection and follow up on the maintenance operation at any time." For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a former CIA officer was sentenced on Monday to 42 months in prison for leaking classified information to a New York Times reporter about a failed U.S. effort to undermine Iran's nuclear weapons program, according to the Justice Department. Jeffrey Sterling was convicted of disclosing national defense information and obstructing justice in January in federal court in Virginia. Dana Bonte, U.S. attorney for the Eastern District of Virginia, said, "For his own vindictive purposes, Jeffrey Sterling carelessly disclosed extremely extremely valuable, highly classified information that he had taken an oath to keep secret. The Justice Department said that in 2003, Sterling gave information about the clandestine program to a reporter for the New York Times. The reporter, James Risen, fought for years to avoid testifying in the case, saying he could not discuss his sources. He eventually appeared in court, but answered only basic questions about his 2006 book, State of War, in which he described the operation in Iran. Sterling's conviction was a victory for the Justice Department under the Obama administration, which has come under criticism from journalists for aggressively prosecuting unauthorized leaks by government employees. The Justice Department said that in 2000, Sterling, at the time a CIA employee, tried to take administrative and civil actions against the agency. When those moves were unsuccessful, he leaked information about the weapons program in retaliation. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
Markets went into a frenzy today after the price of money suddenly skyrocketed to $90 a dollar. Onion reporter spoke to economics professor Mark Cosgrave about the soaring cost of U.S. currency and the impact of increasingly unpredictable dollar-to-dollar rates.
Right now, money prices are steeply rising with no signs of slowing down. This morning alone, the price of dollars nearly tripled, with 1 cent worth approximately $6. That's exponentially higher than even a week ago when money was trading at roughly $53 on the dollar. To put it bluntly, we're now in the midst of a national economic crisis.
According to Cosgrave, the abrupt spike in dollar prices initially caused many Americans to hold onto their money, hoping that the $90 cost of dollars would soon dip back down. But as prices continued to climb, investors panicked and began purchasing as much money as possible.
But with the cost of quarters hitting $4.97 and the $5 bill jumping to a 12-year high of $372, the days when you could get $30 or $40 for just a couple of bucks are unfortunately long gone.
This is the Onion News Network.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. You can join us here toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online over at freetalklive.com. With you in studio tonight, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And join us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. You do have to send a contact request first. But once that's done, we'll approve it. And as soon as we notice, it just takes usually about a show segment. We'll spot it, approve you, and then at that point, it's easy for you to call us via Skype. We've already talked about smuggling of birds and prohibition of ownership and sale and trade of animals, and how that is resulting in species that are endangered becoming more so endangered, that there are more animals, those animals that are dying as a result of the fact that they're now being brought into the black market and smuggled and put into really dangerous kind of shipping conditions. What happened recently was that two dozen cockatoos were found shoved in one at a time into water bottles.
So like individual plastic, water bottles, like yeah. A liter bottle or something.
No, not even. I don't even know if it was a liter. Maybe. But I'm thinking 2 liters. So, yeah, maybe just kind of like a standard 20-ounce or 24-ounce water bottle, what you normally carry.
A bottle
around.
Big enough to put a bird in.
Yeah.
Just barely.
So if you want to put a stop to that, then the only solution is to legalize the trading of animals, to legalize the ownership, the raising, the sale, and the possession of animals. There's no other way around it. There's no set of government rules that is going to satisfy the people who want to protect these animals.
Well, there probably has been some instance somewhere where the government's put some kind of rules on protecting an animal and has, you know, that animal has increased its population, and you can point to that and say, look, we had a success. I'm thinking of, for instance, the Florida alligator. When I was a kid, the alligator was called a threatened species, or maybe they called it endangered before they had the term threatened. I'm not entirely sure. I'm remembering back to the early 80s. And this was in Florida. And everybody in Florida said, this animal is not endangered.
Yeah.
But essentially, they had said that, meh. Like the idea was what I had heard all along was is that basically the government didn't know what the hell they were talking about when they stopped people from hunting alligators. And then at some point they're like, oh, yeah, really, there are a bunch more alligators than we thought. Looks like we saved them. Uh-huh. And I'm sure that there are instances like this, and maybe sometimes these laws have worked, and that's really awesome that they have worked. I'm not saying every single time that you're going to have problems with your prohibition on this, but I'm willing to say that it is less effective than simply making it legal for people to buy, sell, and trade. You know, protect your wild species. If you've only got a breeding pair left of, in the wild of Western black rhinos, protect, you know, put the laws in place to protect them, and that's fine. But let people possess babies and these sort of things in order to be able to breed them, because there's currently, as I understand it, not even any captive Western black rhinos. And this is because somebody said, well, we can't do that. That's bad. We don't want to have zoos have these things because zoos are bad. And, you know, there's all these stories behind them. So if you just allow people to trade in them, that will solve the problem. I want wild animals, you know, out in their habitat as much as anyone, but that means that we're going to have domesticated ones so that people get what they want, whether they want a tiger penis or a rhino horn or whatever it is that they want.
Is that a thing, tiger penis?
I believe it is.
Yeah, it's a fertility treatment in the Far East.
You're supposed to eat it?
I don't know.
I don't think it's a suppository,
I believe it's dried and ground, and so I don't know if you snort it or make tea.
Oh, my.
Ingest is probably safe.
Yeah. All right, so share your thoughts here on smuggling animals, legalizing them, and let's talk about some other smuggling now. There's another story. This one's from Vice.com, one of my favorite news websites. This is about the dark web. Now, we've talked a lot about the dark web here on Free Talk Live and have been following the case of the Silk Road very, very closely with Ross Ulbricht, who was actually going to be sentenced at the end of this month. It was going to be in the middle of May. He'll be sentenced at the end. He's the guy who's found guilty of running the world's most infamous underground drug marketplace. But these drug marketplaces also sell other things, so fake IDs. I don't know if they have an animals category. I'll have to go and check it out. See if they've got any illegal animals that they're selling there in the underground on these dark net websites. But there, according to Vice.com, there have been tales of suspected controlled deliveries by police and seizure letters from customs agents that are so prevalent in the dark web community that some have written them off as FUD, fear, uncertainty, and doubt, planted by law enforcement to dissuade people from buying drugs online. Others merely think.
Do you remember the, what was this billboard for think it's dry right now, wait until whatever? Do you remember the?
I remember that story.
Back in the day when, you know, the claim was this billboard existed that, you know, was always talking about how the police had busted this, you know, marijuana and it's dry or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah.
Help me out here. And I don't think I'm doing a good job of explaining it.
I don't know if you remember this, Rich. This was probably a decade ago. I mean, it feels like it's been forever since we talked about this, but we had people calling. Were we a local show when that happened,
yes,
Mark?
Yeah.
This was a long time ago then. So
we were still in Sarasota, Florida.
Yeah. Were they calling saying it was in the area?
One guy called one time and then other people were like, yeah, I saw it, man. I'm not really sure where.
So the claim was there was a billboard saying, if you think it's dry now, just wait a week or something like that. I forget what the time frame was you were supposed to wait.
As though you could deploy a billboard in that amount of time. I mean,
wait, what? What would the billboard...
Well, yeah, billboards stay where they are for a long time,
yeah, okay,
and they take a long time to get out there. You would have to have
print
them
it
printed.
Up.
And,
or maybe
and
it was just wait till the summer. I don't know what the time frame was. But it was like, if you think it's dry now, just wait. And I think it was supposedly from some drug interdiction squad, the DEA, or you know, the local drug task force. I don't know who was the supposed sponsor, but it was some sort of prohibitionist group. And it seemed like an urban legend because everyone who called about this sign, they never would admit to having seen it themselves. It was
or they
always,
wouldn't be able to tell you where they saw it.
Right. It was always someone who they knew who'd seen the sign, or like Mark said, they couldn't identify the actual location of this sign, this supposed gloating sign from the DEA. And
as though the DEA's ever made it dry as far as marijuana goes.
It would actually be fun to look that up now and see, you know, what the internet knows about those supposed signs. But Mark, what was the point you were making by bringing that sign up?
I'm not even sure now. You know, there's just a failure, I guess. I'm not entirely sure.
So anyway, the idea here from the Vice story is that there's these stories of busts happening from these underground marketplaces that are so prevalent, but there's no real, there hasn't been at least.
Oh, there was the urban legend aspect evidence. Of it, that this is an urban legend.
Okay. That there hasn't been much evidence of these actual cases. So people are telling, you know, there's claims on the dark net about all these busts, but there's very little to actually point to as far as here's some proof this really happened. Now it looks like it's actually happened. The case of the United States of America versus Harold Bates, who's been charged with drug trafficking, might change those skeptical perceptions. It reads like a darknet drug user's nightmare. According to a court memorandum from April, Bates's case began when U.S. Postal Service investigators opened a suspicious package containing methylone, a synthetic stimulant similar to MDMA, and found that an IP address originating from Bates's home in Massachusetts had been tracking the parcel and others like it sent to him from Hong Kong.
Ah, the tracking.
Bates also received USPS notifications about the package's status on his personal email account. So first up.
Bad plan.
Yeah, let's get it right out there out front here. This guy screwed up. He ordered drugs from some manufacturer in China or Hong Kong or whatever. They shipped it to him. They gave him the tracking information, but, and he, with no protection whatsoever.
No VPN.
No ProXPN or
anything. He didn't use ProXPN, and he didn't use a throwaway email address.
No, he used his own personal email address. You know. He didn't use Tor. You know, he could have put in different levels of security on top of this when he was going. If he really wanted to check the status of the package, he could have used Tor. He could have used ProXPN. He could have actually used Tor through ProXPN. And then he would have been, I think, much safer in doing that. But let's talk more about the case.
You
probably
think.
True.
Yeah, let's talk more about the case. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. The dark net isn't perfect, but usually it has more to do with the errors of the users than the network itself. There's more coming up on Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts here, and we're also on Skype at username lrn.fm.
Get the stinky dog away from me.
PD stopped eating. All his hair fell out.
Mounds and mounds of fur.
Our hairballs have hairballs.
Bad breath and bad gas.
Chew himself raw. Sticky, gooey, smelly. She scratched incessantly.
At least $5,000 in vet bills.
And all it took was one container of Dinovite.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
The omega-3 fatty acids.
Flaxseed, zinc, alfalfa.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
Adding Dinovite to their diet has every single dog in my kennel looking better than they have ever looked.
The shedding has stopped and the itching has stopped.
Tons of energy, no more bad smell.
She has gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen.
Everything we tried failed except the Dinovite.
My vet was completely blown away.
Dinovite's the bomb.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Who did you let down today? Your wife? Your kids? Well, how about yourself? Take a look in the mirror. If you're tired of your drug and alcohol problem, you need to fix the problem and right now, before you hurt or kill yourself, or worse yet, somebody else. Call the addiction specialist now at the Detox and Treatment Helpline, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. If you have private insurance, we specialize in finding you the right treatment. When you call right now, you'll speak to a recovering addict who understands what you're going through right now. Let us help you break your addiction to drug and alcohol before it's too late. This call is completely confidential and free. So if you have private insurance, take 5 minutes of your time. Call right now. I promise it'll change your life. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. 800-208-5187. Call right now. 800-208-5187.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls if you make them. You can bring up anything you want. And we'll talk more about the underground drug marketplaces where a takedown has happened of one alleged drug dealer there. Although it sounds like he was actually a buyer in this particular case. We'll tell you more about it, though, here in moments. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number, because most dealers do have to buy their product at some point. So I think that he was buying from a wholesaler is the impression that I'm getting, with the intention of probably reselling. But we'll continue with that discussion. And you can also bring up anything you want. We talked quite a bit about the illegal animal trade and how to protect animals by legalizing them, by making it legal to own and sell them. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And Mark, you're going to Freedom Fest, aren't you?
I am. I'm looking forward to go to Freedom Fest. It's going to be from the 8th through the 11th, July 8th through the 11th, 2015, at the Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas. So it's a great venue. And it's going to be a lot of fun. I'm really going to enjoy myself. There's all kinds of big names that are going to be there. This is the largest gathering of free minds in the world, and it's called Discover the New American Dream this year. The big deal, probably the biggest deal ever at one of these events, is the debate between Paul Krugman and Steve Moore. Now, Steve Moore is the Wall Street Journal columnist and chief economist for the Heritage Foundation. Paul Krugman is the Nobel Prize winning economist and New York Times columnist and, full on Keynesian, right? They're going to debate austerity versus stimulus, red state versus blue state, flat tax versus progressive tax. I want to hear what Krugman has to say on these things. I know what I think when it comes to economics, but this guy is going to be the very best at defending what it is that's the opposite of it. And I'm just fascinated what's going to go on. Peter Thiel, Steve Wynn, Steve Forbes, John Mackey, Harris Rosen, other successful business leaders are going to be there. There's also going to be Grover Norquist, Congressman Alan West, Senator Mike Lee, Steve Forbes. I'd already mentioned him. Sorry about that. George Gilder, John Allison, Glenn Beck, John Fund, Steve Moore, of course, Star Parker, Justin Amash, Floyd Brown, Joseph Farrar. Lots of big names are going to be at this event and giving speeches. It's plenty of time as far as the 8th through the 11th, and they've got a huge vendor room. So I'm excited to go. Please come out and hang out with me. When you sign up at freedomfest.com, please mark that you heard the ad on the radio. Radio is the term that they're using to describe Free Talk Live. I guess they're not doing any other radio ads. So there you go. And also you can call them on the telephone if you don't have the internet available to you. It's freedomfest.com or 855-850-FREE. It's really close to our number, as a matter of fact. 855-850-FREE for Freedom Fest, freedomfest.com.
Let's go to Ron. He's in Durham, North Carolina, listening to Talk Radio 850. Hey, Ron.
Hello again, you guys.
Welcome.
Interesting show, as always. Hey,
can you do me a favor? Back off your phone about an inch. I'm sorry, you're a little bit distorty on our side.
Right. Yeah, I'm going to actually pull over here, trying to quiet the road noise down in my old 92 GL Metro that I'm driving around.
I don't hear any road noise. It's just coming from you just kind of blowing the phone out a little bit.
What kind of gas mileage are you getting on that GL Metro?
Well, depends on how I drive it. Depends on if the AC is on. Now that the weather's broke, it's running rich from being choked. But I get between 47 and 50 miles per gallon if I take it easy.
Wow.
You're sounding better now, so go ahead, Ron. What were you calling about tonight?
All right. I didn't talk about my Metro, but anyhow, first of all, I wanted to say I listen to you guys on an AM radio station out of Raleigh, and the guy on that comes on before you, Bill LeMay, he's on from 3 until 7. Did you guys ever think about, like, say, calling some of the bigger market stations and trying to, you know, do interviews with the people that are on? Because I mean, I think that, you know, more exposure, you guys could really catch on a whole lot more around.
So let me explain briefly. When we're on a station, the program director of the station, I always inform them, hey, if you ever want Free Talk Live hosts to come on your local shows to, you know, talk about an issue or something like that, we're always happy to do it. Some stations avail themselves of that. Others don't. And
also, when there's big news items that are, you know, New Hampshire-centric or Keene-centric, you tend to send out emails advising your program directors that interviews are available on that subject,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, so they know. I mean, they know that we're here. They know we're available. I don't have the time in my day to call individually on each host of a local station and pitch my show or myself as a guest to that person. I just rely on the program director to, you know, alert them that we're available if they would like to use us. But what I would suggest to you, Ron, is that if you feel like it would be fun to have, was it Bill, to have Bill have one of us on or both of us on his show, I might, if I were you, suggest contacting him or his producer and, you know, just making that suggestion and see what
sure,
they say.
And, you know, I call him once in a while. I do talk to him, and I'll definitely do that. I mean, a lot of their topics would, you know, segue right into the sort of things you're talking about, vice versa, you know. But anyhow, cool. Yeah, I'll definitely do that for you. Something else I wanted to mention briefly as well, there was an article that I had read about smuggling. It ties into the smuggling, as you guys were talking about earlier.
Mm-hmm.
With cannabis being legal out in Colorado, along the western border of Kansas, the state police were, you know, petitioning the legislator out there that they're going to need more money because they've diverted a lot of their resources into the interdiction of smuggling.
Oh, so now the cops next door to Colorado want a bigger budget because there's supposedly more marijuana coming across the border.
I suppose it makes sense.
Right. And a couple legal of marijuana from their neighboring state. They're talking about less able to enforce other laws, you know, and, you know, longer call times and all that kind
right,
of stuff.
Right, they're trying to keep everybody safe from the scourge of cannabis that's coming flowing across the border. Rich, what were you going to say there?
You know, I don't remember,
that's
but
right.
What I want to say now is I wish that somebody would keep us safe from the scourge of government.
Yeah, right?
I agree, man.
Ron, thanks for sharing that with us tonight, dude. I appreciate hearing from you, and thanks for the call at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Virgil is with us in Ohio via Skype. Hello, Virgil.
What's up, bro? Good evening, guys. How are you?
Hey, what's on your mind
tonight? My Bishop of Ohio.
Yes, the church is doing very well in Ohio, Rich.
Groovy.
What's this,
glad
the Church of the
it.
Invisible Hand?
Yeah.
Oh, excellent.
Yes, we have growing membership. We're doing wonderful. I have a quick thing to run by you guys, mostly because I was, for the last couple of days, this has been unfolding as a story. There's a police department here about an hour and a half away from where I live. It's called Lima, Ohio. It's the city of Lima. It's spelled like Lima, Peru, L-I-M-A.
This is where Glee is based, the show.
Yeah, I believe that's the case. It's a really crappy town. You don't really have any reason to go there unless you just want to be depressed. Or I don't know why anyone would go to Lima, Ohio. But
go to the restaurant Breadsticks.
Yeah, right. But last year, there's a big case in Lima about a 19-year-old kid who was basically caught by cops drinking at a party somewhere. And they pretty much... Yeah, they beat this kid to near death, more or less. Yeah. And then they charged him with a felony for assaulting two of their cops. And
what did he assault him with? His puke?
I mean, I don't know.
A lot of times they'll charge you with, you know, assault just for touching a cop. I mean, just because you hear somebody... Just because you hear the claim that someone has assaulted a cop doesn't mean that they've actually slugged them or done any real damage.
Right.
Hang on, Virgil. We'll bring it back here for the rest of the story in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a four-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit 2% caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your four-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
LRN.FM needs your help getting our satellite signal back on in Africa. Our satellite provider had us on at no charge from 2012 through February of this year when they pulled the channel off the air. Now we're trying to raise $22,000 to continue reaching people with the message of liberty in places where it's needed most. Please visit our Indiegogo fundraiser at africa.lrn.fm. Give what you can and share the link with your friends. africa.lrn.fm. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome back here. We'll take your calls toll-free at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, you've got me, Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Rich Paul here, courtesy of his Church of the Invisible Hand. It was just mentioned a moment ago with Virgil. Apparently is one of the what was it, the priest?
Bishop minister? Of Ohio.
Bishop out there in Ohio. One can go to Facebook and type in the search bar, Church of the Invisible Hand, and that will pull up your Facebook page, which is right now the premier web presence for it. Would you say
mostly, but there are different ministries of it. There's the 420 Foundation, the Union of Unemployed People, and Motley Anarchism page. Also, if you go to richpaul.freekeen.com, mm-hmm. There's a list and pointers to all of my projects, so you can like them all or like only the ones you like.
And also ways to donate to your efforts as well.
Oh, yes. It's always good to feed an activist.
So that might be the most important URL to give out then, richpaul.freekeen.com. We'll take you right to a page that'll link you to all of your projects and donation links.
Yep.
As well as subscriptions as well. You just recently added subscriptions to that page. So if somebody wanted to help you out with $5 a month, that'll help, you know, feed you at least once a day right there.
Absolutely.
So, all right. So our toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. As we continue with Virgil in Ohio, you were calling about some kind of case and you barely had really a chance to scratch the surface. So someone was charged with assaulting a police officer while they were being arrested for underage drinking at a party. Is that right?
Yeah. Basically, initially they charged this 19-year-old kid. They pretty much beat him to near death. They couldn't even take him to jail. That evening, they took him straight to the hospital. He was in bad, bad shape. They initially charged him with a couple of misdemeanors, but once they found out that he was going to pursue some legal options, they pretty much dropped a felony charge on him immediately.
Oh, wow. That's the safest bet for him is, whoa, right. You're going to believe the word of a person who's charged with a felony?
Yeah. And then to make things worse, they even forced a toxicology analysis of his blood, and then they posted the results on their Facebook page.
Oh, my God.
And on
That's
top
classy.
Of that, I mean,
that
these guys
classy.
Are out of control. They are out completely out of control, and they've been basically deleting any critical comments of users on their Facebook page for the last year. So I want to pick your brains because I drove to Lima today. I attempted to have some interviews with some of the cops, especially the one running the Facebook page, their law director. None of them would want to talk to me because to me, this is a clear violation of First Amendment rights, as this is a city-run page and is managed, you know, around the clock by taxpayers-paid employees. What do you guys think about this?
Well, I think you're absolutely right. I think if you put a page up there and you allow public comment, that the government for them to manipulate that comment and silence critics is a violation of the First Amendment, a censorship based on the content of speech. And it would be okay for a private company to do this. Okay, private company is a completely different thing, but for
as long as they don't business with the government, in my opinion, a private company that has government contracts, I got a different feeling about.
That's a good argument,
but I probably won't have it right now.
So that was my argument too from the very beginning. In fact, there is at least one case out of California where someone filed a lawsuit against the San Diego Sheriff's Department for basically the exact same thing. They settled out of court for about $23,000 plus $20 for his own expenses. The $23,000 were attorney fees. So this guy wanted to make it clear that he only wanted $20 out of it. He wasn't in for the money. So the case wasn't really settled after a trial. It was basically settled out of court.
Yeah, as so many are.
So there's no case law established. And these guys are pretty much hardened in their ways. I advised them again today that they are violating people's constitutional rights since this is a government page.
We tell you what the Constitution says, citizen. Get the hell out of here.
Yeah, he would have none of it. He said, I don't believe so, and we'll continue to do what we've done for the last year. And honestly,
whoa, you've got an official response from some cop telling you we're going to keep
it on video.
Wow.
I have it on video, yes. And
we don't care what the Constitution says because we have lawyers that are paid with your tax money to fight this, son.
You
don't get to decide what the Constitution says.
I think that Lima, Ohio, is north of there, bro.
Yeah,
that was in Lima, Kentucky.
Yeah, that's like Boss Hog or whatever.
That would be a northern Midland accent, is what they would have in Lima normally.
Go ahead, Virgil.
Yeah. So anyways, my way to corner them, to put them in a quarter in Ohio, government agencies are actually required to store and retain all correspondence with the public. So I basically filed a public records request with them last night, asking for all the deleted comments from Facebook that they have moved.
There's no way they're going to have that information, right?
Of course not. Of course not. So they kind of put themselves into a corner here. I'm very curious to see how they will turn this over. If they will not, they're in violation of state law. If they will, I'm very curious to see who they have removed comments from and what these comments contain.
How in the world would they know what the comment? They don't have any record. It's like, oh, this person said that. Let's get it out of here.
Facebook has them. But
Facebook might be able to get them, and then
of course you might be able to subpoena that information from Facebook.
Yeah, they might be able to subpoena it. Yeah,
the cops wouldn't bother with that. They're not
right.
The cops aren't going to send a subpoena to Facebook over that.
But if you were engaged in a larger lawsuit, I don't know what the rules are for a subpoena from a third company or from a third party, but Facebook almost certainly has that data.
Well, if
on
there was an
file.
Right, they certainly do. If there was an order from a judge in the middle of a lawsuit, to where the judge sends an order to Facebook saying we need this information, then they would do it. But you certainly can't expect the police department to independently send
The police department is motivated to do exactly the opposite of contact Facebook and get this information.
But it's thousands and thousands of comments. The mother of this kid, Tyler's mother, I met her today and I did an interview with her and him as well. She said she was banned from the very beginning, from the time of his arrest. They blocked her from their Facebook page from commenting.
What a bunch of thugs.
I know. So this is crazy to me. It's such a humorous but also sad story because these cops are pretty much running around both in the physical world and in the digital realm. They're acting as if they are not subject to any rules. And, mostly that's why I called to pick your brains and see if you guys are kind of agreeing with this or am I just stretching my understanding of the legal world there.
I think you're absolutely right. Cops do walk around and act like they have no rules that apply to them. Yes.
And frequently they are correct in that, and frequently they are not. You've got to look at the risk-to-benefit ratio. You might get a friendly judge. Where New Hampshire is an advantage, is an example of some place where that's happened a couple of times, and Free Staters have won sizable judgments. So it does happen, but you have to be in front of the right kind of judge.
And it's less about money for me. It's more about just fixing the wrong. And fortunately, the Southern
you got a lot of wrongs to fix, my friend.
I know. Well,
you might as well
this.
Get paid. I mean, look, I know that you're a great activist out there and everything, but you've got them on this one, I think. And if you've got them, then you might as well take some cash for it because, you got to pay the bills.
If you don't want to keep the cash, you can always donate it to the church.
We will do that. Sounds good, Rich.
Yeah, man. Keep us in the loop. Is there an article up or the video up over at your website yet?
It is. Go to truthvoice.com. It's on the very top of the page. You also posted to CopLock yesterday. And the Lima Police Department, they actually had to take the page down for about an hour yesterday because they were receiving so many negative comments from cop blockers that they could not keep up with deleting them. So,
oh, wow.
They're going to need to hire some more staff. Now you've given them a reason to expand, Virgil. Nice job.
A reason to expand, but keep in mind, if they could tax us any more without causing a revolt, they'd be doing it already.
I think you should be ashamed of yourself. These people probably have a blister on their delete finger from this. I mean, cops' lives matter, Virgil.
Hey, Virgil, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Truthvoice.com. Go get the story there. 855-450-FREE is our number. We'll continue with the dark web here in moments. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business? CEO?
MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation.
Because if you're not incorporated in someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special early bird price of just $50 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $50 price only lasts through the end of June, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
We're back with more Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you to dial in. Join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Where one of the ways you can support the show is by supporting yourself through buying advertising with Free Talk Live and helping your business, product, or service.
Yeah, if you're going to do that, you need to understand the difference between push advertising and pull advertising. So pull advertising is like Google AdWords, where, you know, a consumer goes out looking for whatever they're looking for, and you try to pull them in with your ad away from all the other people that sell that same thing. Then there's push advertising, where you're pushing your message out to about your great products and all that sort of thing out to people who weren't necessarily thinking about them at that moment. And the intention is to sort of create business in that way. And radio is push advertising, as really broadcast mediums are generally. And in the course of the week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks that listen to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message.
And James in Arizona.
And yeah, they could hear your message. And we're having a sale right now. It ends at the end of the week. It's for 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's 230 second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. All you have to do is contact me, mark@freetalklive.com. I'll get it reserved for you. Yes, we can do it in the course of a conversation. So it's mark@freetalklive.com.
All right. We were talking earlier in the hour about the darknet, the underground marketplaces that exist in the darknet. There's a lot in the darknet, and underground drug marketplaces are one of those things. We were talking about somebody who's an alleged dealer on the darknet, who's now been arrested, and some of the mistakes that this person made, namely the fact that they were checking the United States Postal Service website, their tracking tool, from their own home IP address, and further, they used their own email address to sign up for tracking updates. So that's,
kids, don't try this at home.
Yeah, that's what led the police to this person. Or I guess what led them to this person was they found the package in the first place, which contained methylone, which is a synthetic stimulant allegedly similar to MDMA, and then they looked into it further and found his IP address checking on the package. According to a USPS representative spoken to by Vice.com's author here, packages are only opened after a warrant has been issued unless they are ticking, leaking a hazardous substance, or have a strong odor. This suggests that Bates's package either had bad stealth, which is slang for camouflaging the package's illicit contents, or that Bates was already known to investigators. In short, bad OPSEC, or Operations Security. Stephen Dowd, a USPS investigator, took up the case and organized a trash pull at Bates' house, essentially going through his garbage, and found the familiar trappings of drug trafficking: cut-off tops of plastic baggies, a box for a digital desktop scale, receipts of Western Union wire transfers to China and Hong Kong, and empty Chinese parcels that were addressed to Bates. A few weeks after the trash pull, Bates began using a friend named Julia Carosi as an intermediary, whom Bates paid in gas money and gift cards to, quote, avoid arousing suspicion, unquote. The packages were addressed to Carlosi, and she then handed them to Bates once she received them. According to the memorandum, Carlosi was under the impression that Bates was ordering weightlifting supplements that were not yet approved by the FDA and had no further involvement with respect to the drugs. After Dowd, the investigator, determined that the packages addressed to Carlosi were actually ordered by Bates, it's not clear how exactly from the filing. A USPS sniffer dog named Lucky indicated that a package addressed to Carlosi either contained or was in close proximity to drugs. Dowd arranged for a controlled delivery. After Lucky alerted, Inspector Dowd drove the packages back to Rockland, donned a letter carrier's uniform, and attempted a controlled delivery to Carlosi's home.
I wonder if that's legal, donning unless you're a mailman, if you can wear a mailman's uniform. I would imagine it's illegal for everybody.
This was the postmaster.
He's a postal inspector. Okay. This is a postal cop.
Okay.
So I suspect it is fully legal for him to dress as a postal worker.
He is a postal worker.
Right.
His employer is the United States Post Office.
All right, I'm getting it now.
So he goes to Carlosi's home to attempt the controlled delivery, but says the memorandum there was no answer. Dowd left a package slip and returned the parcels to the Rockland Post Office. After Carlosi picked up the packages, police witnessed a handoff to Bates in a Rite Aid parking lot. When more packages for Carlosi arrived days later, Dowd intercepted them and asked USPS employees not to enter an arrival scan. Instead, he took them and once again had Lucky sniff them. The dog barked. Dowd then obtained a warrant.
Does it seem strange to you that they've got a dog that alerts on methylone? I mean, this seems like a pretty I would think that this would be a pretty minor thing to train a dog for. Can you only train it for one type of drug?
I would imagine that dogs could be trained to pursue multiple kinds of drugs, but that's actually an excellent question.
Yeah. I don't have an answer for you. If you have an answer, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Dowd then obtained a warrant and organized another controlled delivery to Carlosi. A fake entry scan for the parcel was made 24 hours after it was expected, a late delivery. Ignoring possible red flags thrown up by a delayed delivery, Carlosi showed up and received the package. Bates was arrested during the handoff. During the court proceedings, Bates moved to have the contents of the parcels inspected by the USPS officials suppressed. His argument was that his expectation of privacy was violated by inspectors because the packages addressed to Carlozzi were sniffed without a warrant. The motion was denied because he effectively relinquished control of the packages to Carlozzi, who in turn did not have her own expectation of privacy since she was merely a bailee with no control over access to the package. All of this illustrates how, on the dark web, paranoia reigns to the point that truth may seem like fiction, but sometimes the truth is far more thrilling. So here you do have a case with somebody who was allegedly operating on the darknet. Now, the thing they're not revealing here in this motherboard article over advice.com is how they knew this guy was a dark web drug dealer. So all we've got here so far is that he had ordered a supply from Hong Kong and was busted. You know, they looked through his trash and they found some what could be related to selling of drugs kind of paraphernalia, like, you know, baggies and a box for a scale. So in theory,
but if he's got baggies, then he's probably not, he may well not be selling it over the dark web. If he is reselling it, that sounds like it might be, because they talked about cutting off the tops of baggies, which doesn't sound like a very professional pack job. It sounds like something a street level dealer might do.
Yeah, it could be, unless we're talking about him like vacuum sealing things and then cutting off the tops of the vacuum sealed packages. I'm not really sure about that.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
It'd be interesting to get more information on the case and, you know, exactly what makes them suspect this guy was a dark web drug dealer. So what we do know is he was ordering supply of methylone from Hong Kong, and that probably means he was dealing it. Because unless he was just constantly dosing on this himself, odds are good he was reselling. But I don't really consider this to be an example of somebody getting popped on the dark web. He was doing money order transfers to, or not money order, but MoneyGram Western Union transfers to whoever it was in China that was selling him these products. So he wasn't using the dark web to buy these products.
Yeah, I mean, how does this qualify as dark web at all?
It may well be that he was using dark web to place the orders, but that it wasn't a Bitcoin site. Is all dark web by definition Bitcoin?
No, but the dark web markets tend to be Bitcoin. So
if you're not, he didn't use a VPN, which says to me that you know, he's not even on tour at that point, right?
He didn't use a VPN when he contacted the post office. He may well have used VPN and Tor and everything else when he contacted the seller.
This guy thought he had some kind of a Harry Potter magic cloak of invisibility or something, because he didn't use any standard practices to protect himself.
Well, he wasn't expecting it to be considered a suspicious act to check the package because he didn't think anybody knew what was in the package.
Agreed.
So, you know, the
still sloppy
real issue. Well, it's sloppy. I gotta say, I don't know what I didn't deal in that sort of thing, but you know, methylone would not be something that I would expect to be sniffed out. I'm with Mark on that. It strikes me as very strange, and it probably isn't something I would have protected against a great deal. Although, you know, I doubt I would have gone to the U.S. Post Office site. That's just
toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts here. Bring up anything. Jess is on the line in Elgin, Illinois. You're on Free Talk Live listening to WRMN.
Thanks. So I heard a guy on a talk show the other day. He seemed knowledgeable about dogs. He was saying that they're not cross-trained, so there's cadaver-sniffing dogs. And basically it sounds like they're trained to do one specific thing, so they don't get maybe too confused or something.
Right, they're generally not cross-trained as far as the body dogs cannot be drug dogs, but drug dogs, I suspect, can sniff out more than one kind of drug. I don't know if you have more to say, Jess. You're welcome to stand by if you do. If not, thank you for the call. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More on the way here. The solar roadways. Somebody actually installed them. We'll tell you about it coming up on Free Talk Live.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org, A-L-C-O-R.org. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.43 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,194 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $243. Antiwar.com reports U.S. officials are expressing sentiment similar to other analysts that in the recent weeks, the Syrian government's momentum has waned and that President Assad faces even more risk from the assorted rebels. The big surprise, however, is the admission from the officials that Assad's loss means gains for the Islamic State and Al-Qaeda's Nusra Front, the two largest rebel factions, and that will be the primary beneficiaries of a fading Assad. U.S. officials have often tried to present the war on the Islamic State and the war for regime change in Syria as separate things and have insisted that they could work simultaneously to undermine both Assad and the Islamic State. In reality, the U.S. simply does not have any meaningful allies left in Syria, and they're desperate to the point of trying to create a new rebel faction just so they have someone to back. And despite admitting a huge problem with their current strategy, General Martin Dempsey insisted U.S. policy towards Syria will not change and they'll remain hostile towards both the Islamic State and Assad at the same time. In Survivor Max by Davi Barker, 11-year-old Max must survive the zombie apocalypse alone in New Hampshire. Slow-moving and non-thinking, the lame brains swarm his home searching for living flesh. Max must apply his porcupine freedom scout training to plan his escape, but first he must prove that he's too smart to die. Look for Survivor Max on Facebook and Amazon, or read Chapter 1 free at SurvivorMax.com. UPI reports an off-duty Saudi Arabian Airlines plane was seen receiving routine maintenance at an Israeli airport, causing the airline to cancel its contract with the Portuguese firm. The airline, known as Saudia, said HiFly, a company leasing planes to the airline, landed the plane with prominent Saudia markings at Ben Gurion Airport in Tel Aviv, Israel, a violation of its contract. Saudi Arabia has no official relationship with Israel and has led the Arab boycott against Israel since the 1970s. The plane, an Airbus A330, was serviced at the airport last week by Bedeq, an Israeli company contracted by Israeli Aircraft Industries. A Saudi plane arriving in Israel was a novelty noticed by Israeli media. The Saudi newspaper Arab News, quoting the contract, reported, "Such landing or operation process should take place in a country that shares diplomatic relations with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia to enable Saudia staff and civil aviation authorities to conduct inspection and follow up on the maintenance operation at any time." For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a former CIA officer was sentenced on Monday to 42 months in prison for leaking classified information to a New York Times reporter about a failed U.S. effort to undermine Iran's nuclear weapons program, according to the Justice Department. Jeffrey Sterling was convicted of disclosing national defense information and obstructing justice in January in federal court in Virginia. Dana Bonte, U.S. attorney for the Eastern District of Virginia, said, for his own vindictive purposes, Jeffrey Sterling carelessly disclosed extremely valuable, highly classified information that he had taken an oath to keep secret. The Justice Department said that in 2003, Sterling gave information about the clandestine program to a reporter for the New York Times. The reporter, James Risen, fought for years to avoid testifying in the case, saying he could not discuss his sources. He eventually appeared in court, but answered only basic questions about his 2006 book, State of War, in which he described the operation in Iran. Sterling's conviction was a victory for the Justice Department under the Obama administration, which has come under criticism from journalists for aggressively prosecuting unauthorized leaks by government employees. The Justice Department said that in 2000, Sterling, at the time a CIA employee, tried to take administrative and civil actions against the agency. When those moves were unsuccessful, he leaked information about the weapons program in retaliation. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
An update now on a legal battle emerging around the Onion News Network's own Jode Kressbeckler. After the shocking story yesterday that a group of assailants attacked Congressman William Cummings, tied him to a horse, and dragged him through a briar patch, some are now saying these statements from Mr. Kressbeckler last week may have incited the attack.
Bootlegging Congressman Cummings ought to be tied to a horse and dragged through a briar patch.
Mr. Kressbeckler's show is billed as an opinion and entertainment program.
Yes,
and
it
he
is.
Even calls himself nothing but a caterwauling old badger, so
right.
The claim that he would incite people to violence seems pretty far-fetched.
He displayed a map of Congressman Cummings' home in relation to the nearest briar patch, told his viewers where to purchase a, quote, good pulling horse, and used a life-size dummy of Congressman Cummings to demonstrate effective knot-tying techniques.
Right. You know, I think most reasonable people would see that as simply a ribald political satire.
Right.
Briar patch is obviously a metaphor for the prickly political atmosphere in Washington, and drag from a horse means something else.
Makes sense to me.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live will take your calls about whatever you want to discuss here. Toll free, 855-450-FREE. Coming up, the solar roadways. Somebody actually installed these things, and they appear to be working. Mark's got the story on that, plus related story about big rigs that can drive themselves. So that's all on the way. You can bring up anything you want, though, at 855-450-FREE. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. And also in the studio tonight with you, you've got Ian.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Let's go to the phones and to the fun first, where we've got Jimmy on the line in Arizona. Jimmy, you're on Free Talk Live via Skype.
How are y'all doing?
Hey, what's on your mind tonight, Jimmy?
It's been a while. I know Mark has got kind of frustrated at that FNRG, that Force Field Energy.
Uh-huh. Know? This is a company that had advertised stock on Free Talk Live in the past.
Yeah, I bought 100 shares of that stock.
Mm-hmm.
And but I'm not upset, you know.
Well, that's
I can
good.
Take the hit. You know, I run a successful goat brothel, so I stay pretty busy.
Now, when you're running a goat brothel, does that mean that you're taking human customers for goat prostitutes?
I'm not too picky. I'll take whatever I can.
Are the goats?
Well, I mean, if y'all want a testimony, James from Arizona, he's more than willing to let y'all know how good it is, and you know that I'm on the up and up, and everything's good.
Oh, he's a client,
right? Yeah, he'll give a testimonial.
Yeah. He wrote a great review on Yelp and
Yelp in more ways than one, I imagine.
Yeah, he seems to like it a lot, though. He's always over there, you know, and he wakes me up in the middle of the night trying to come in. I'm like, man, you know, leave me alone, James, you know, and he's like,
That's the worst. I mean, that is one of the worst parts about running, you know, an underground business like that is the customers that will try to come calling at 4 a.m. when you need to get some sleep at some point. That's frustrating.
I used to have a sign on my door on Church Street that was just an open, open closed sign. And it looks strange because it was just on the outside of an open of an apartment door. But mm-hmm. when it was flipped over to closed and people would come banging on my door, I would open the door and I would just stand there and point at the sign. And I wouldn't say a word. I'd just stand there and look at them and point at the sign that said closed until they got frustrated and walked away.
This is back when you were selling weed out of your apartment, right?
Yes, yeah. It's true.
Jimmy, thanks for the call tonight, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's continue here as we go to Ken. He's on the line in Minnesota. Ken, you're on Free Talk Live. Hello.
Yes. For years, I suffered with depression and stuff, and I actually figured out a way to overcome it. So many people that are committing suicide and stuff. I put a video up on YouTube. It doesn't give no address or no phone number, no website. I'm not trying to sell anybody anything. It's just information. And I was wondering if I could mention the YouTube video.
Well, first of all, I want you to tell me a little bit more about what putting a video up on YouTube has done to help you with your depression.
I haven't been depressed one day in 19 years. Well, 8.5 years to be exact.
Is it some kind of supplement, or is it a way to think, or what is it?
Yeah, it's more clearing your mind and using your conscience, or your common sense.
Okay.
To evaluate the real things from the false.
What would one search for on YouTube if one wanted to find this video?
Okay, the title of the video is Healing Can Be Yours.
Okay. That's...
And it works for people who are crippled or blind or cancer or anything.
Can you give us the Cliff's Notes about what one thinks about in order to heal cancer?
Well, sure. Your body, you know, is positive and negative. We're electrical beings, you know. I mean, after you see the video, you'll understand. I mean,
well, not everybody who's listening to the radio show has internet access. So, I mean, that's why I think Mark is asking you for a summary of. I mean, are we just talking about positive thinking here? Because I agree with you that I think that positive thinking has a real effect on people's bodies.
At the very least, you can die with cancer with a positive attitude.
All right. Yeah, but no, this is different. It's a Christ-centered message.
A Christ-centered message.
Okay.
Yeah, see, Christ says, given to those who ask.
Well, why doesn't he give to everybody?
But there's people who believe in Christ who have cancer, right?
Yeah, but believing ain't enough. You have to see him.
You have to see him.
You have to ask. Yeah, you have to have your pineal gland open.
And you do that with DMT? I mean, how do you open your pineal gland?
Well, see, God's law. The Ten Commandments, they work like a plow, what John the Baptist was telling people, make the path straight. Okay? And when you apply that law, it plows up your hard heart, and he comes and sows his seed in it. And that's really how it works.
Don't most people follow the Ten Commandments on a daily basis? I mean, the first four is honoring, is it four of them on honoring God and all that stuff. And then it's like, honor your father and mother, and then don't steal, and don't bear false witness, and those sorts of things. I mean, I would think that the average non-believer wouldn't be running around bearing false witness or killing folks or stealing from them.
You'd have to be careful of your definition of graven images, though. Isn't that a commandment?
Well, I would say anybody who pledges allegiance to the flag is probably bowing down to a graven image. What about that?
Idolater, definitely.
Also, the people that bow in these churches. See, that doctrine comes from Charles Finney. In 1724, he was given a hellfire brimstone sermon, and people started to faint. So they carried him down to the front and propped him up on the pulpit. He bent down and prayed over him, and that's where you get the altar call. That's nowhere in the Bible.
Nope, no, altar call's not in the Bible.
So what you're trying to say, and let me, you know, correct me if I'm wrong on this, What you're trying to say is that in order to have Jesus heal cancer and other maladies, that you have to see him physically?
Through your pineal gland.
Through your pineal gland. And the the way you do that is what?
You use his law. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. So you follow his teachings and the good Ten Commandments as though your life depends on it. And you will fail. Each time you fail, it will be agonizing, like a woman giving birth. Christ compares it to that in John chapter 17, verse 16 through 24. Anyway, at the seventh time you fail, your pineal gland will be open, and you will see him. Once you see him, you can ask him. He says, ask, and you will receive.
Just to clarify something, are you saying that you have to break the Ten Commandments seven times before your pineal gland opens up, and then you finally see Jesus?
You can't keep them. It's impossible.
Right. So what you're saying is, you're trying to adhere to the Ten Commandments, but because you're human, you're fallible, you're going to fail. And when you fail for the seventh time, Jesus will appear because your pineal gland opens and you trip, basically, and see Jesus.
Oh, I've violated the Ten Commandments way more than that, if you count adultery as anything outside of marriage. And I've never...
Well,
I guess I've seen Jesus a couple of times, but he didn't heal any cancer.
But it's though your life depends on it. It's not superficial.
So wait, you're saying that other people like Rich Paul have not been serious enough. Like if you're not seriously trying to obey the Ten Commandments, then the failures don't count.
And the teachings of Christ.
Huh?
And the teachings of Christ. You can't leave that out.
How many times have you seen Jesus? I'm just curious.
Just the once.
And what did he tell you?
He did not speak a word.
How did you know then what the purpose of that meeting was?
From what was revealed to me, through me, what I've come to know.
It's pretty
was
far
he,
out, man.
Was I he a white guy or did he look kind of Arabic?
No, he was an illuminate being.
No beard?
White but opaque.
No beard?
No beard. That was plucked out.
Ken, thanks for the info tonight. What was your YouTube video again? We'll give you another plug.
Did he have ID?
What was it again?
Healing can be yours.
All right, Ken. Thanks for the call tonight. I was entertained. 855-450-FREE. He seems to believe it.
Oh, he believes it. God bless him. I mean, if he's had whatever success he's had, that's fine by me.
855-450-FREE. You know, you can also probably open your pineal gland with some DMT from what I hear. It's Free Talk Live.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th. Get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com now.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realist, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237.
That's 800-686-2237.
Cato University is the Cato Institute's premier educational event of the year. It's being held this year from July the 26th to the 31st at the Cato Institute's state-of-the-art headquarters in Washington, D.C. This annual program brings together outstanding faculty and participants from across the country and often from around the globe, with everyone sharing a commitment to liberty and learning. Cato University is a genuine community, and you can freely share viewpoints, concerns, ideas, questions, and more in an atmosphere of friendship and personal respect. It's a one-of-a-kind program for people who don't stop thinking after they got out of school. It's for people who don't want politicians or bureaucrats or officials to do their thinking for them. It's for people who value liberty. You'll learn, you'll be inspired, you'll make new friends, you'll meet great people from around the world. All of the details are spelled out at the Cato website, cato.org, and they hope to see you there this summer, July the 26th through the 31st in Washington, D.C. Again, details are at cato.org.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. With you in studio, you've got Ian here.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And I was just looking through recently an episode, or not episode, but I guess an edition of Entertainment Weekly on my phone via the Next Issue app, which you can go and get for yourself at nextissue.com/FTL. That's where you can sign up for your free trial, get a $15 savings on what is essentially the Netflix of magazines. It's only better with access to all of the latest issues. You get 150-plus magazines at your fingertips for the price of about two magazines at a newsstand. So the monthly price of about two magazines at the newsstand, you get basically more magazines you could possibly read.
Yeah.
So you go through the list when you get the Next Issue app installed on your phone. They'll show you all the magazines they have accessible, everything, you know, big names, ESPN, Sports Illustrated, Men's Health, Esquire, Car and Driver, Maxim. I was just looking at Entertainment Weekly, Consumer Reports is one of my favorites, and many, many more. You can go and get your free 30-day trial. There's no commitments. You can cancel anytime. It's available for iPad, iPhone, Android tablets, and smartphones. You can go to nextissue.com/FTL. Plus, there's digital extras. So I was just looking through the Entertainment Weekly's summer movie preview. You wanted to see what the movies are that are coming up this summer. There's, you know, the new Terminator, Jurassic Park. There's going to be some big movies hitting this summer. And
Ant-Man.
And so it's not just like you're reading through a regular magazine. When I clicked the summer movie preview for July, there's like an index page which shows you all the listings of the movies that they reviewed, or that I guess previewed. They're not reviewing them, but they're previewing. So you then click the one that you want to jump to. So you don't have to flip through a bunch of pages to try to find what you want. There's a lot of
And then there's probably the preview that's available too. You can't get that out of a magazine.
So so go to nextissue.com/FTL, get signed up for your free trial. And again, you can cancel anytime if for some reason you don't much care for it. But if you love magazines, this is the app for you. Nextissue.com/FTL. Get signed up for your free trial right now. As we continue here, we'll talk to you about anything you want to discuss and via Skype as well, where Dave is on the line in Montana. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, Paul, and Mark.
Hey, yo, Free Talk Live. How you doing?
Hey, Dave.
Hey, I got a police dog story. You want to hear it?
I do. Yeah, tell me.
All right. My sister got married down in Florida. I was living up in Montana, so I took a greyhound down to Florida.
You're still living in Montana, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
This was a while back.
Got it.
So, anyway, we get to Shreveport, Louisiana. And then all of a sudden, cops come on the bus. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
And I for the trip, it's a four-day trip on the bus. So I rolled up a quarter ounce into joints in my backpack.
As any self-respecting Greyhound traveler should do.
Oh, God. Man after my own heart.
So anyway, the cops come in Shreveport, Louisiana. The bus gets raided.
Crap.
Like, so anyway, they empty the bus out, and they make the... everybody take their luggage out from underneath. I didn't have no luggage underneath. I just had a backpack. So they made everybody put their luggage in front of them. And
whoa.
They had these black labs show up. So this black lab is coming down the thing, man. And he sniffed out, starts barking at these two guys. And they pull out something out of their bags. And here comes the black lab up to me. And all I'm thinking is, I'm going to be on one of them chain gangs with the striped suits and stuff.
You're in Louisiana at this time? Where was this?
Yeah, that's the worst place.
Yeah, this is the worst place to get caught with weed.
Shreveport, Louisiana.
Yeah, Shreveport,
right?
Yeah.
So anyway, here comes this beautiful-looking black lab about three people down from me. So I mind-melded with them, man. In my head, I went, "You're a beautiful black lab. Oh, wow." And he kept kind of looking at me, and I kept looking right in his eyes.
Aww.
And every time he come closer to the next person next to me, I just looked at him and tell him, "Please, please, I'm all right. Don't bust me, man. Just don't bark by me. Please, please." I kept talking to him and looking at him. He came right up to me, looked me dead in the eye, put his nose right where I had my joints all rolled up, looked up back at me, and walked to the next guy.
Wow. I swear.
It happened, right?
It's crazy, man.
I totally believe it. Mind meld all the way. You know, there are, I think there's, you know, what is, I forget who said this. I cited it the other day. I'm sure somebody can do a quick Google search and tell me, but, you know, there are more things in the heaven and earth than are dreamt of in your philosophy. Who was that?
That was from Hamlet. There are more things on heaven and earth, Horatio, than are
all
dreamt
I sent
of in
was
your philosophy.
Good vibes to that dog, man. I was just totally aiming really good vibes to him, man.
Right on, peace, brother. Thanks for sharing the story. It was a good one, Dave. I appreciate hearing from you tonight. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I buy it. I think that's legit.
What I like best about the story is it's believable, and nobody can walk away saying the best way to handle a drug dog is to mind meld with it, right? Like, at the same time, there's, you know, no matter what are the results, nobody's going to walk away from this saying, "I'm safe to bring as much weed as I want in a Greyhound," because all I have to do is maintain eye contact with a Labrador.
Well, there was positive vibrations.
They don't teach that in drug dealers.
There was positive vibrations involved there too, Mark. If you maintain eye contact but are afraid of the animal, that is going to send out a different set of vibrations, right? And so the idea behind the sort of vibratory viewpoint here is that everything is vibration, that everything that that we're seeing around us, everything that appears very hard and solid and, you know, whatever, it's all vibrating. It's matter vibrating, energy vibrating at a certain frequency, and that, you know, is perceived by our senses, essentially.
Okay. Well, that doesn't sound like bullcrap at all.
True? That's not bullcrap. That's
things
like
do vibrate.
Physics,
there's
man.
Certainly things vibrate. There's no doubt about it. Things vibrate. I got you,
right,
brother.
So the idea here,
this is
from
a
Dave,
damn dog, okay?
Excuse me. Dogs are like 96%.
Have you ever seen a dog that's excited? They really vibrate. Yeah. Right. These animals have emotions, Ian. Where
they
not
do.
Vibrating. They have. He connected. If this story is true, and
every
I
every emotion
it
has a vibration behind
no,
it, Mark.
You lunatic! There's nothing to do with vibrations when it's an emotion.
How do you know that?
He made an emotional...
How do you know that it's not? You're the one making a claim. I don't have to make a claim. Show me the vibrations.
The vibrations,
an emotional connection with the animal, and the animal, smart, dumb, or whatever, connected with him and decided to do whatever it decided to do. That's fine. Animals have emotions. I'm clear on that. Vibrations, hocus pocus nonsense.
Well, wait, so you're saying that you don't... Okay, so what you're saying is you don't believe that you can send good vibrations out, that you can...
You can send sort of good vibes, if you want to use that terminology.
That's what I'm talking about.
But what I mean is, I can look at you and I can try to be, like, send good feelings towards you. It's not that we're vibrating,
but we know,
dude.
That's not happening because you have a black heart, and so therefore you couldn't possibly be sending good feelings.
Yeah, I've had years to
one
try.
One of the girls who played with Joan Jett.
Hey, I put a nickel in this jukebox too many times, and the guy just...
I can't prove it to you, Mark, but I'm on board with Dave here. 855-453.
How did I get off board with Dave?
You don't believe in the vibration thing. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention, do you owe money to the IRS or have years of unfiled returns? Are you being audited or receiving threatening letters? If the answer is yes, you need help. The IRS can seize your property and assets, impose fines and penalties, garnish your wages, and even go after your bank account. Don't take on the IRS by yourself. Don't let the IRS destroy your life. Take action now. Call our team of experts for a free and confidential initial evaluation. We've helped thousands resolve their tax problems. Let us help you. 800-261-7073. 800-261-7073.
So Mark and I are out at the range shooting our AR-15 rifles built from AR-15 kits from Guns80.com when Dave walks up and he says, "Hey, did you guys hear about Jade Helm? You know, the government doesn't care about the Posse Comitatus Act, and Jade Helm, the troops are going to come and they may come after us and blah, blah, blah." And I'm thinking, oh my God, dude, look, I take a 30-shot magazine, I put it in my AR-15 built from a kit from Guns80.com, I unload it on the target. Jade Helm? I mean, really? Guns80.com, Guns80.com, Guns80.com. Go now.
There are two types of advertising. Pull advertising, like Google AdWords, where a consumer goes looking for widgets near them and you try to pull them in with your ad away from the other widget purveyors. Then there's push advertising, where you push your message out about your great widgets and attempt to convince people who weren't thinking about widgets at all that what they need in their life right now is your widget. Radio is push advertising. In the course of a week, there are probably over 250,000 good folks listening to Free Talk Live, and they could hear your message. We're having a sale right now, and it ends May 15th. 200 30-second ads for $1,997. That's like 10 bucks an ad. Find another show with that kind of rate with 150-plus stations. Email me, markedge@freetalklive.com, and I'll set you up. You don't need to have an ad. We'll produce it for you. Buy 200 30-second ads by May 15th and get them for less than $10 a piece. It's a big savings, and you don't want to miss it. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com, now.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
A fully leveled up video game character marvels at how far he's come, and the milk rushing through a jug handle is having the time of its life. This is The Onion Week in Review. This week, top executives from the U.S. financial sector announced they're about ready to ruin the world again. Representatives from all major banking and investment institutions said that more than enough time has passed since they last caused a major global economic meltdown, and confirmed they're pretty much fully prepared to bring about a brand new worldwide financial crisis.
We feel like we've given people enough time to get comfortable again. Consumer spending is increasing.
increased. Housing market has rebounded. So yeah, we're all set to go ahead and ruin the global economy again.
And in other news, the perfect gift for a local man is unfortunately a gift certificate to Lowe's Cinemas. Mall shoppers look on in awe as a helpless 15-year-old girl is viciously torn apart by a pack of her peers. And a drunk pilot decides to pull over onto a cloud until he sobers up.
You will now hear three gong strikes and a recitation of the great chant before being ushered to the hallowed garden. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to join us here on the radio waves at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you've also got Skype as an option. Skype username's LRN.FM. Ian in studio here.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
And our website, freetalklive.com. You can go and support the show. One of the ways you can do that is by supporting our African Satellite Fundraiser, which will be over in just five short days. So please go to africa.lrn.fm and help us get back on the free-to-air satellite system over most of Africa, a good swath of the continent there. So go to africa.lrn.fm. You can help us reach new ears with the ideas of freedom in places where they don't even have internet access. So this is a big, big thing that we can do. And it doesn't cost a whole lot of money. It's $22,000 for 3 years of 24/7 broadcasting to Africa. So please help us out at africa.lrn.fm. 855-450-FREE is our number. And, Mark, there was a story, I don't know, maybe 6 months ago. Doesn't seem like it's been that long since we talked about solar roadways, which was an interesting technology involving, like, solar panels built as the road. And there's news about it. You're going to give it to us here in a moment. But first, we're going to Mike in Oregon. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Rich, Paul, and Mark.
Hey, guys. How you doing tonight?
Mike, go ahead. Great. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Hey, just wanted to let you know, awesome, awesome, awesome video the other day, Ian and Rich, of you guys going up and haggling Maggie Hassan up at the college.
Hassling would be awesome. A more accurate term. Haggle. To haggle would be to argue over price. But yeah, we did give the New Hampshire governor a hard time for 5 solid minutes as she awaited to enter into the graduation ceremony of Keene State College. And we've gotten some heat for that, Rich Paul. So it's nice to hear people who appreciate it.
Oh, yeah. Well, we didn't give her hell. We just told her the truth, and she thought it was hell.
It's true. I'm sorry, Mike, what were you saying there?
Oh, I was just going to say, I mean, it's good that you get in heat because it's better to get no reaction at all. When you get, even if it's negative attention, it's still better than no attention. You know what I mean?
Well, there are some people who would disagree with that statement, but yeah, I tend to agree. Either they're talking about you or they're not talking about you.
Exactly. So realistically here, I know, you know, it'd be great to, even though I live in Oregon now, but like, I'm talking realistically.
Oh, what did you just say there? I'm going to have to just, it sounded like the F word. What did you just say? I'm sorry.
He said he was living in Oregon.
I said now I'm living in Oregon now. I was just wondering realistically, do you think she's going to sign marijuana legalization into law, or do you think she's going to keep it illegal? I'm talking realistically now.
I don't think legalization's on the table this year. I don't know what the status of
that is. Decriminalization is what he's referring to.
Yeah, decrim is the bill that is currently in the Senate. The New Hampshire State House passed it with over 80% of the House that was voting on that day. The House State of Representatives, the 400 of them, there weren't all 400 weren't there. So if you look at all 400 and, you know, how many voted, it was like 74% voted for it. But if you look at the ones that were present that day, 80%+ of the ones who were present voted for this. It was a tremendous, overwhelming support in the State House. We don't yet know how the Senate is going to vote. There's been some talk about that they might actually pass it this time because it died last time in the Senate, the last time decrim was brought up in New Hampshire. And it's come up several times, so maybe this is the year where the Senate will pass this. Hassan has not yet pledged to veto it, but essentially she's suggested she's going to veto it. It seems likely she's going to veto it, but I suppose there's a glimmer of a chance of maybe
0.01% chance that she may actually sign this thing. But I wouldn't get my hopes up.
I just, you know, realistically looking at this, you know, I mean, every time, I mean, because she knows where it's coming from. It's coming from the free staters and the liberty-minded people.
Well, no, it's not. It's 80% of the state reps who voted for it. I mean, that's coming from everybody.
Yeah, I mean, one of the reasons I chose marijuana reform as an issue is it is very popular with the general public now, which wasn't true when I became a libertarian in, like, 1995. And Libertarian Party people always used to say, oh, drug, you know, soft pedal that legalization of drugs thing. People think you're crazy, but it's become very mainstream since then.
I don't know, Rich. Yep. What do you think? Is she going to sign this thing? Is there a chance?
Oh,
of that?
I'm absolutely convinced she's going to veto it.
Yeah,
or she's going to do what she's done before, which is basically convince the Senate not to pass it, so she doesn't have to veto it.
Yeah, I think that this is, you know, she's beholden to the police unions. If she turns yep. on them, they'll do what they can to get her out of the office. She doesn't have the luxury that the previous Democratic governor had of this, you know, this 80% approval margin or anything like that. She's going to be hanging by a thread come election season. She doesn't want to be, you know, exposed to the Republican. So I expect her to veto it like she said she's going to, but
she hasn't said
it. Do you expect her to run for governor again?
Yeah.
No. The word is she's going to run for Senate.
Then
U.S. Senate.
Then maybe that's the case, because she doesn't need the police unions for U.S. Senate.
So there you go, Mike. That's our best predictions, which aren't really worth a hill of beans. Anything else you want to share?
I mean, well, I was going to say, too, because I don't understand, like, you know, she's vetoed it how many times, and I mean, when it gets to her desk again, what makes you think that she's, I mean,
it's never gotten to her desk. She's never had to veto it. Governor has had to veto marijuana decriminalization. As I understand it, I'm not an expert historian on this, but my understanding is this year could be the first year it's ever passed the Senate. So that would mean that it has never made it to the governor's desk before. So there you go.
Okay.
Mike, thanks for the call, man. I'm glad you enjoyed the video. And the video, by the way, that he's talking about, you can go to freekeen.com, scroll down a little bit. You'll find the video there. It's of me and Rich basically haranguing the governor. I played actually almost all of the video on the air on Saturday night show. So if you're listening then, you caught a good chunk of it. But it is fun to watch it, because then you can see her reactions. Which,
as a minister, I like to think of it as a public shaming of a sinner.
I think that
A lot
of people really didn't like it. Like, it's just a little too much for them. You know, most of the comments were positive, but some of them were negative, right? And it was just
always going to be negative.
We were running 20-1 thumbs up, thumbs down on YouTube. Right. So we're definitely doing pretty well. But there were naysayers.
But just to be clear, the YouTube views and the thumbs up and thumbs down changes over time. So frequently what will happen is a video that we'll put out will go amongst the Liberty crowd first, and so it'll pull a bunch of thumbs up. But then later on, it'll get out among other people who don't care about freedom. So there's videos that have been thumbs up in the beginning that have later gone to more thumbs down, simply because somebody posted it to Reddit, and the people on Reddit are just, you know, a bunch of status, and so they all thumbs down it. So and Derek J's victimless crime spree actually has more thumbs downs than it does thumbs ups.
Another thing that we don't that no one ever gets to really see is that this governor makes a concerted effort not to speak to the constituency. She doesn't want to hear from us. So
nope.
It's, you know, you've called many times as the press. You are the host of a nationally syndicated radio program on 150 stations.
Based in New Hampshire.
She won't talk to you. She wouldn't give you the time of day.
I can't even
get
her
press secretary
to call me back.
The only way you can speak to this woman is to go to some commencement speech where she's been asked to give some kind of you know, short speech. She's not even the anchor, as I understand it. And badger her, because she cares that little about her constituents.
She's insulated herself that far. And so I'm glad you pointed that out, Mark, because there's some people who've been critiquing Rich and I on this, and it's not like I haven't gone through the normal channels. Prior to this incident, I have attempted on multiple occasions, not just with this governor, but the one before her, to reach out to these people and to try to contact them through the sort of traditional means of being nicey-nice media folks, contacting them for comment on something or an invitation on to be a guest on a show or whatever. And I can't even get a call back from the press secretary, and it's been that way for years. So a couple of years ago, I decided that okay, I've had enough. Next time I see this woman, I'm going to grab my video camera and
ambush
I'm going to ambush her.
Yeah.
And that's what I've done ever since I, you know, decided she didn't want to talk to me.
What are you supposed to do?
Did you try calling her press secretary while wearing a suit? They seem to think that suits are very important for these things.
Well, at this point, Ian's name is enough to keep her from ever talking to him. She's never going to talk to any of us. She knows what she thinks. She has no intention of representing anyone else. The 80% of representatives that voted for this, she doesn't want to represent them. She's going to represent the people who give her the payoffs.
855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number here. You can join us in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live coming up next.
I'm Steve Sitkowski, a former Wall Street insider. I'm holding a book that will show you investing strategies which could help you earn the kind of money you've always dreamed about. And right now, I'm giving this book away for free. So who needs to read it? If you're in the middle of your career and worry you'll never have enough money to retire, you need to read this book. If you're already retired and your income isn't enough, you need to read this book. And if you don't want to be selling burgers at 80, you need to read this free book. It includes the strategy I use to make a 72% profit on a trade where the stock only moved 12%. You'll need at least $1 million to ever fully retire. If you're behind on that goal, you really need to read Trade Like the Pros. And you can for free by calling 1-800-944-5836. Skeptical that it will deliver results? It's a free book, so what do you have to lose? Find out how at 1-800-944-5836. 1-800-944-5836.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a 4-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit to per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your 4-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Stouffer's, helping bring your family together with wholesome dinner options, even on the busiest of nights. Find dinner table ideas to bring your family together at letsfixdinner.com. To get kids involved in dinner time conversation, ask specific questions, not broad ones. Instead of what happened today at school, try what was the best thing that happened today. The more specific you are, the more they'll have to say. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us via Skype at Skype username, lrn.fm. Tonight, Ian here.
Rich Paul.
And Mark.
Don't forget to check out Rich on his sort of donating slash linking site, richpaul.freekeen.com. You can go and get more Rich there and his various projects, of which he has a few.
Come on by and get rich quick.
So let's talk about roads, Mark. Everybody likes roads.
It's solar frickin' roadways was how it was kept on being described on the internet. And
Oh, really?
From sciencealert.com, the solar road in Netherlands is working even better than expected.
Wow.
The Netherlands made headlines last year when it built the world's first solar road and energy harvesting bike path paved with glass-coated solar panels. Now, 6 months into the trial, engineers say the system is working even better than expected. With the 70-meter test bike path, not very long, generating 3,000 kilowatt hours or enough electricity to power a small household for a year. So 70 meters.
It's not bad.
Yeah, it's 200 and about, you know, call it 210 feet, 200 and maybe 50 feet, something like that. That's the length of, it's, you know, quite a bit longer than, say, an average lot's length. So what that says to me is that the length of road outside your house cannot power your house.
Not yet.
If that's
what if you add your driveway?
Maybe your driveway, but then you're going to park cars on it. I think you're probably better off doing things on your roof, which would be also you don't have to, I don't know, get dirt on and bubble gum and, you know, shade trees and a variety of things. Anyway.
True.
One of the things that I remember hearing about these solar roadways, these are the sort of the hexagonal looking panels or octagon.
They don't
panels.
Show pictures of that here, but yeah, I mean, that's what I saw.
And they're made out of glass, and beneath the glass, they have the solar devices.
This is not the hexagonal ones, I mean, in this picture from what I'm seeing, no. But it is a solar roadway.
Okay. What does it look like?
It just looks like a big panel that's covered in mostly dirt.
Now, what were the critiques of the solar roadway? Wasn't one of the critiques that...
I wouldn't want to drive a 3,000-pound careening death machine down a glass surface at 70 miles an hour. That's one of mine.
Meaning that if it were wet, for instance, that could be a problem?
That it could be a problem. They don't mention that in the article. They also don't mention how much they spent putting it down. Mm-hmm. I think that that, to some extent, is fair because the you know, once you get to the economy of scale, it's going to be cheaper to make one of these. You can't say that the first 210, 250 feet of this isn't commensurate to the value of, you know, a 100 miles after you've produced a million miles, if that makes sense.
So, but what you're saying is they're not answering some objections here. They're not going to tell you, oh, well, here's what's people's experience with stopping if it's been
raining. It's only for bicycles, Ian.
Right.
So they don't say what has happened with bicyclists. They don't say that anybody has you know, been smashed or anything like that. They do say that it is strong enough to support a 12-ton to support 12-ton fire trucks without any damage. They say that they have only had one that's not operating. One of the panels is not operating or whatever, so they had to sort of shut that down and make it work. They're pumping their electricity straight into the street lighting or the grid. Mm-hmm. Engineers spent 5 years creating the system to be durable. If one panel's broken or in the shadow or dirt, it will only switch off that PV panel, says the one of the engineers. More than 150,000 cyclists rode over the panels during the trial, and so far they've only noticed one fault. A small section of coating, which provided grip to the surface, has become damaged due to temperature fluctuations. The team at a solar roadway is now working to improve this coating. Hmm. We made a set of coatings which are robust enough to deal with the traffic loads, but also give traction to vehicles passing by. So I guess it's like, you know, crossing.
So, yeah. So they're putting something over top of the glass that will still allow the sunlight to pass through, but give some sort of traction. So will that, this coating, I guess here's the question, right? So the idea is these are supposed to be long-term solutions, that these panels are supposed to last for a long time. But does the coating last for a long time? And so how often does a recoat have to go over this? Is that where this company is going to, you know, bring in the constant money from governments in upkeep costs on this? And
I don't know. I mean, I would think that governments, local governments tend to worry about costs a heck of a lot more than, you know, bigger governments do. I think you had to put out a bike path of, you know, 250-foot bike path stretch that had these solar panels on here so we can see. Because there's no other way to do this. There's going to be the naysayers on the internet to say, this will never work. And that's fine. Maybe it won't work. But the only thing they can do at this point, governments have a near monopoly on bike paths, right? So you can, you know, either try it out on a private company or try it out on the government. And the Netherlands is a fine place to try it out. There's lots of bike paths there. So I think that this had to be tried out. Hopefully we can find out some real numbers at the end of it. I'm not satisfied with this article in the way that they went about explaining things, but I'm heartened, I suppose.
I'm sorry, you probably already told me this, but how long has this trial been going on?
Six months.
Okay.
What they're saying here is I wanted to read you this one part. The potential is pretty huge. Not only could the roads generate enough electricity to power local households, but they can also provide some amazing lighting opportunities. Last year, a solar road was installed in the Netherlands by Design Lab Studios Rosengard, which sucked up the sun's energy during the day and then guided cyclists at night using the beautiful Vincent van Gogh's Starry, Starry Night inspired LED lights. So
that's cool.
It lit up the road, and they're coming up with ideas and whatever. We've got to have some steps forward in road technology.
Please, it's
about
time.
I don't know what they are. I'm not claiming to know what they are, but I can tell you here in New England, where we have freezing and warm temperatures, that they can't keep a road for like 3 years
here. No, it's awful here. So I guess another question I have is, what is the, you know, with in New England, you mentioned the freezing, the temperature changes creates these things called frost heaves, which basically destroy the road. So what happens with glass when it freezes? Is it as susceptible to the temperature differentials, or is it more likely to stay stable?
Well, I think you're going to have probably just bigger heaves. You know how oftentimes with a sidewalk, when you have that, it won't crack down the panel of the sidewalk. It cracks along those little things that are made to crack in the sidewalk. So it'll bend, and you'll have these plates that are going down the road. And, you know, we'll see how that goes. Do you understand what I'm saying?
But is glass susceptible to freezing, and, you know, is it going to shrink and expand in freezing?
Everything shrinks
all
and expands. Yeah, in different heat. Frost heaves aren't from the road freezing. It's from
the
stuff under the road freezing. And, you know, moisture under there, you know, pushing it up, and then in the spring it melts and goes back down.
That's another question that I have then is this is the Netherlands. It's obviously been cold there over the last 6 months, right?
That's why the coating came up, was because of temperature differentials.
Mm.
So we don't know. I don't think we're anywhere near to seeing whether or not this is the next step in road technology.
Yeah, there's a lot of work that needs to be done here.
But I really want to see whatever that is. I don't think roads are going anywhere anytime soon, even if we do get flying cars.
Yeah.
There's a lot of reasons that
all
roads
cars
are good
will
things.
Not become flying cars when the first one is rolled out. So there'll still be a lot of other.
Well, plus freight's important too, right? And moving thousands of pounds of product is just going to make it economically makes more sense to put it on the road.
And maybe the best thing
that
they can do is just keep those repaving things constantly moving on the roads. I don't know, but where I live, the roads are crap, and even when they do fix them, they're all in a few short years, maybe five, they're already bumpy and full of holes again. And so they just need to keep a constant crew of these things going down the road doing stuff.
And that's good for the crew, but it's not good for, you know, the people that are paying that crew. It'd be nicer if we had roads that lasted for a decade or
everybody
two
always
decades.
Talks about how the government is supposed to, you know, what without the government, who would fix the roads? With the government, who the hell is going to fix the roads?
Yeah, they do a terrible job.
We've got
job.
Governments and the roads are crap. Also, I'd like to point out that traffic jams are the result of the people that build the roads, too. If you've got bad traffic in your area, that's not just nature. That's the government messing things up.
So I'm excited. I mean, I think the solar roadway is a really cool idea, and I'm hoping that this works out for these guys. And it sounded from what you said like there might be a couple different companies that are designing this. So that's good. That means there's already competition in the area. And I was actually talking with somebody who was a big fan of solar power, and I didn't even realize, but apparently solar power has gotten a lot better in the last decade or two. And it's, you know, the cells or whatever that pick up the sunlight are more efficient now than they've ever been. They have new ways of doing it to where they can actually put solar panels on your windows that are see-through, essentially. So you don't even know they're there, but they're still picking up sunlight. And there's, like, all kinds of developments. I'm not following it closely, so it's exciting when I hear about it. There's a lot of cool stuff going on. Check out our website, freetalklive.com, between now and tomorrow night, when we'll be back to talk to you again on Free Talk Live.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadadi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Rebel Love Show is next, live after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Tuesday, May 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.43 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,194 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $243. Antiwar.com reports U.S. officials are expressing sentiment similar to other analysts that in the recent weeks, the Syrian government's momentum has waned and that President Assad faces even more risk from the assorted rebels. The big surprise, however, is the admission from the officials that Assad's loss means gains for the Islamic State and Al-Qaeda's Nusra Front, the two largest rebel factions, and that will be the primary beneficiaries of a fading Assad. U.S. officials have often tried to present the war on the Islamic State and the war for regime change in Syria as separate things and have insisted